he's lying.
Look, I'm rolling, all nigga. I'm saying, nigga, is that the Dak Prescott shit, that played in his favor, bro. The fact that he can't throw down the field.
Nigga, he threw down the field. Stop playing. Yesterday, he was launching that bitch.
How he ain't throw down the field when he threw down the field?
Nigga, a touchdown. Did your man throw a touchdown?
Did your man throw a touchdown?
Yeah, he did. No, he didn't.
He didn't throw a touchdown.
Nigga ran.
He didn't throw in the cover, Kerwood. With the two down the seam to the right.
Yeah, that was that push off. Bitch ass push off. You know it was a push off. They've been cheating for y'all.
How many flags did y'all get before that?
Nigga, all them fumbles, y'all couldn't even do shit.
Your D-backs got three penalties on them. Your D-backs got three penalties on them before that.
You hear me? Niggas had four fumbles.
We didn't call.
Four fumbles. My quarterback. And them niggas didn't do nothing after that shit. Kick a fucking field goal. Can't even do that.
So are you proud of that win, nigga?
Fucking right, nigga. Stop them niggas at the 1 yard line, nigga. Fourth and one. Who the fuck they are?
Drew Brees at 10 points. You better be proud of.
What type of running backs? Who running backs?
You can't do it twice.
Who running backs? Ours, nigga. Ezekiel. That's it. They need two that ain't do shit.
Look, them niggas is good.
Both of them.
But it won't happen again.
Both of them ain't do shit, bro.
All y'all did was just limit Drew Brees' time of possessions, bro. That's all.
That's what you're supposed to do.
He's never had top-notch receivers.
Any good quarterback, you keep them niggas off the field.
Of course.
That's how you beat them. Keep them niggas off the field.
And keep your offense on the field. Yeah. Now, the Dallas Cowboys offense on the field for a long time, you goddamn something's bound to happen. I'm throwing that motherfucker 5 yards every play.
I better complete that bitch
22 times.
Come on, man.
Then he completed 22 times in a row. He set a record last night, right?
23.
23 in a row, he set a record. Nigga, I'm throwing 3 and 5.
He threw 10 yards, 15, 20.
Okay, a few.
He ain't launched none because your boy ain't launched none. Fuck you thought.
But you know how we get down.
Not against us.
You know the resume.
Not against us.
You know the resume.
Not against us.
You know the resume, man.
I don't know how y'all work against us. Man, we did great.
Bro, I expected all this, bro. That's all I'm saying. I expected all this.
Y'all gonna see each other in the playoffs again? You winning your division?
If they're there.
LA?
I'm winning my division.
They have trouble beating everybody else. So getting back to us is a different story. Beating us is one thing, but you gotta get to us. We beat everybody else.
As long as Green Bay isn't in it, we have a chance in the playoffs. Because Green Bay cheats us every year. They cheat us every year. No, we get to the playoffs.
Two
motherfucking years. They did it to us twice. That's why I don't fuck with them niggas. Fuck 12.
Replace the CH with a B and cheat, nigga.
Y'all niggas cheated twice.
Beat you niggas every year.
Nigga, we ain't the Vikings. Don't talk to me like that.
You right.
Facts. Vikings.
Hey, it still wasn't a catch.
Do we want to be badmouthing the Vikings on this?
Hell yeah.
Fucking right. Fuck the Vikings, man.
These niggas beat the Jets and think they the shit.
Fuck, they beat us and think they good.
Nigga beat the Jets.
Good this year.
Look at us. We are the shit. We beat the Jets. We beat the Bills. Fuck out of here. Now, Tom Brady's coming up in this month. Oh, no, they going to Tom Brady. Tom Brady ain't coming. Mm-hmm. So,
they finna see Tom. Why come to us, nigga? That's the only reason we lost MVP. Them bitch-ass niggas.
Why would I need to go to Minnesota?
No, I'm talking about Green Bay. Ty Montgomery fucked up the game for us.
Oh, last game? Oh,
few weeks ago.
Yeah, in the beginning of the year.
Fucked up the goddamn game.
Yeah.
That's a lot of
people. He's not here, so what was that? What was the problem last Sunday?
Do too much. Huh?
What was the problem last Sunday?
We just not good right now, bro.
See, ain't he with the Ravens?
Who? Ty Montgomery?
Yeah.
I don't know where the fuck the nigga at.
He dipped, nigga. Y'all let him go.
Nigga somewhere, bro.
I don't know where he at.
We getting into the shits, man.
Yeah.
About to get it started.
It's Friday, nigga. Meek back.
I was being too, I ain't gonna say polluted, but too much Lil Baby. Too much Lil Baby, man. I'm glad Meek dropped, man. Nah, man, it's just he flooding, bro. Sometimes niggas get it and run with it, bro. Yeah. He got it. He ran with it. Some, when you get it, you gotta run with it.
Yeah. Nigga. This nigga deliver, man. My nigga Meek deliver, man.
Speaking to you as a prophet, as rare as they come. Gunshots sound like music hanging out the Buick. Why you wanna be a shooter? Mama told me not to do it, but I did it. Now I'm locked up in a prison. Call her mama like I shouldn't have did it. Watch my
yeah.
Rick, can you read it out loud?
We're gonna get into that. For the picture, like I'm going for we get into that. Hey, shout out to Meek, man. It's Friday.
So,
Meek just dropped.
So, what I'm seeing already. Is out. My bad. I didn't mean to interrupt you, man.
Let's do the intro, man. It's the comment section podcast. What's good? What the fuck is up? It's cold outside, but we about to get it hot in this bitch. It's weed smoke. I got E&J. I got Mike's Hard Lemonade on deck.
It's fucking Friday,
the vibe
man.
Is in this bitch.
He got Mike's Hard Lemonade.
Harder.
Please say the Mike's.
It's harder. It's harder lemonade.
It's harder.
I'm drinking that shit.
This is the chase.
Everybody that was at our table.
It's the chase.
It's the chasers, nigga. Look, man.
But yeah, we here, man. It's Cool Keem, joined by two great individuals.
It's the Juice Man, Shine Dop, man.
Yeah, sure. Who else?
I'm here got? with my confidant. No, I'm just playing.
My comrade.
Yo.
With my brethren.
Yeah, we out here, man. I hope everybody's week has been going good. Made it. It's the weekend. It's time to forget all the bullshit that happened at work this week with your family. I know everybody been pissing y'all the fuck off, so it's Friday. Fuck with us, man. We out here.
Yeah, man. But I was talking about that tweet he just showed us, man.
We getting into the shits already? All right, so Meek just dropped his album. Championships is out now. Everybody's heard the album in entirety, right?
Yep.
All right, I've played it twice today so far.
I ain't heard the whole album. I just heard some stuff.
You heard the shits though, right? The ones.
Yeah.
Because some of it, we already figured out what them ones is so far. He got a few of them ones on there. Trauma is one of them ones.
What that, Gotta Respect the Game?
Nah, I don't really fuck with the shit with Fab. It's just not.
Oh, that's what you said?
Uptown Vibes. Nah, he got a song called Trauma.
By itself, huh?
Yeah. Hard. Hard than a motherfucker. I like the shit with Cardi, the On Me. That's gonna be in your local strip club.
Yeah.
For sure. The bitches is definitely gonna be shaking that shit to that one.
Respect the Game.
Respect the Game was cool. We're gonna get into What's Free. We're gonna get into What's Free. What y'all feel about the Drake joint? The Going Bad. What you feel about it?
I ain't heard it.
I hope Drake wrote it.
That's what I was thinking too. I said that. I wonder if he got a reference.
I bet when he said that, he was like, "Nigga, I hope you really wrote this shit this time.
Please just write the shit this time.
I know
time,
you ain't trying to play me like that, man. Nigga. And send me some shit you ain't write again.
You know what?
What the fuck?
He didn't give a fuck.
Who, Meek?
Yeah.
Nah,
at this point, no.
He's like, man, hey, fuck it. Yeah,
he's been down that rabbit hole.
This is
before.
What they on.
Yeah. Fuck it. Just give me a verse, nigga. I don't give a fuck who wrote it.
Hell yeah.
I didn't really like the song, though. Maybe it's going to be one of the ones that grows on you, but I thought it was like the seventh or eighth best song on the album. Mm. Tic-Tac-Toe. I like the Kodak feature.
Yeah.
I fuck with Kodak, even though the nigga was looking goofy as fuck with the Florida Gators football team. That shit was funny. But the nigga could rap his ass off. I fuck with him. I even like the LMA joint. The LMA joint was cool. She's trying to get her Beyonce on that.
That was cool.
I liked the LMA joint. It was
alright. Hey, all
right. He had a lot of girl joints on there, like the ones that you know was for the chicks. But I like the Dangerous, the toughest. You hear that one? Y'all hear that one?
No, I ain't heard that either.
Dangerous. That's the one with Jeremiah and P and B Rock.
Oh yeah, that's on the radio.
Yeah.
Them niggas snapped on that shit.
That was on the championship album.
I mean, that had to be on the album because how old is that song?
Oh, it's an old song.
I mean, that was
an old song. I don't think I heard that.
They dropped it on the EP. That was the summer EP before that.
Oh.
He had an EP.
Yeah. I don't know that.
That shit's boring. He had another song on there that was tough too.
100 Summers is cool. The only knocks I got against the album is fuck out of here, Meek. He got a song called With the Shits. He didn't do his homework, clearly. Clearly, he can do his homework, nigga, because Empire X got a song called With the Shits. I don't know what the fuck he was thinking. Nah, I'm just fucking with you, but I didn't like the song, though. It was cool.
Can I interrupt you real fast?
Go ahead.
Did you see that new Nicki Minaj video?
No.
Okay. That's why we're talking about Meek Mill.
We're going to get into that. She dropped a video today.
Earlier this week. I think it was.
So what song?
I don't even know. I had the beat bang. I heard the. I had to hear the beat out loud.
It was one of her songs off of
her album. Yeah, her and Lil Wayne. And went crazy. That's gonna go to the strip club.
Her and Wayne.
That song gonna go to the strip club.
Okay.
That's a hit.
All right. Let's save some time to get into that then. I haven't seen that video. Let's watch it. What
they,
else about
they the released, joint? They released the Tekashi album.
They did. Y'all going too fast. We all Meek right now. Let's all stick right, with Meek.
Okay, I mean, okay. I think we gave Meek enough.
Meek is roasting.
We gave Meek enough.
Let's go.
We didn't even get into what's free yet. Come on, man. Let's get into that. We didn't even, you know what I'm saying? So, the ones, though, so the ones I hear everybody kind of talking about is Trauma. I don't really hear people speaking on me, but I like that song. Championships, the title record, which we just played.
Was free.
Hard as a motherfucker. And then What's Free. What's Free is kind of gaining the most controversy
Jay-Z,
right now.
Jay-Z does that every feature that he hops on.
When the God somebody's gets on the track.
No, he don't. If you pay attention. Remember he did that when he was taking shots at Drake on somebody album. Who he was featuring. Oh. He took shots at Drake.
What song was that?
I'm just saying.
What song was that?
DJ Khaled's.
Yeah.
DJ Khaled's out. Mm-hmm. Yep. He took shots at Drake.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's not
John with Future, right?
Yeah.
But it ain't him taking shots at Kanye. It's just the fact he did that to build the controversy up again for everybody. Because
Jay doesn't really talk. He's not on Twitter. He doesn't really give his thoughts in that format. So we know when we get a Jay verse, especially his features, we're gonna get answers to a lot of questions that we've been thinking about. He's gonna fill us in on what he's going through with, you know, because Kanye been trending, and so he's gonna tell us exactly how he feels about some shit. Some shit is gonna be subtle. Some shit is gonna be overt. He gonna let us know exactly what the fuck it is. And that's what Hov do, man. He gets on your album, and that's probably one of the best verses on the album so far. I know it just came out today. Hey, I don't want to be a prisoner at the moment.
I know a lot of people like that song because of Jay-Z's, but if y'all really listen to Rick Ross,
Ross Knapp,
come on, man. That made me rethink. Let's get into it first.
We're gonna play it before we start commentating some more, and let's deep dive into these lyrics, man. This is what I love. It's hip hop, nigga.
Let's go, man. Take down, nigga.
Wait, first, I want to shout out to whoever's on Meek's team, because they had to clear so many samples on this album.
My nigga.
I'm like, they got all these shits cleared, nigga. All of them.
Huge fan of samples.
Yo. How many samples you hear? Every song down there had a sample. Uptown Vibes is a sample.
I thought you were talking about in this song.
What's Free is a sample. Respect the Game, you sampled the Dead Presidents. Championships, I'm sure, is a sample. There's a lot of sample. 24/7 sample Beyonce. So he had to do some work to get this shit out, but I just had to say that. Alright. Yeah.
You know what free is, nigga? What's free? Free is when nobody else can tell us what to be. Free is when the TV ain't controlling what we see. Told my niggas I need you. Do all the fame, you know I stay true. Pray my niggas stay free. Made a few mistakes, but this ain't where I wanna be. Before I'm judged by 12, put a 12 on my feet. Told my niggas I need you.
Since the lad I was cunning, just got a pad out in London. I keep stacking my money, I need a ladder by summer. AK shots, niggas ducking straight shots. Been a top dog, that's before the cake dots. Cracking in 06, immaculate showmanship. Talking like you Mitch, disastrous on the strip. Holding on your bitch, could have never sold you a brick. With them people, you never been on the list. Mona Lisa to me ain't nothing but a bitch. Like niggas swinging from his dick. We so different, you thought these didn't exist. The Megalodon never seen on his wrist. I'm from the South where they never make it this rich. God is the greatest, but Satan been on his shit.
So what?
That motherfucker needed a clue bomb.
He said a few things.
Mona Lisa is just another bitch.
Who drew the Mona Lisa?
Boom, 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 boom.
That's where all the bombs did that shit.
That's where all the bombs come in.
It feels great to hear from Ross. I feel like we haven't heard from Ross in a while.
Boom, 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 boom.
It's always great to hear from the boss.
Get the pavement, I pray I'm illuminated. Over a decade and never nobody's favorite. Party kilo go hand in hand like we gambling huff. My amigo a million grams when we count them enough. You was dead broke, I let you hold it back. You paid for it, but I fuck around and stole the track. Screaming gang, gang, now you wanna rap. Racketeer in charge, just caught him on the tap. Looking for a bond, lawyers wanna tax. Purple hair got them faggots on your back.
What's free? Free is when nobody else can tell us what to be. Free is when the TV ain't controlling what we see. Tell my niggas I need you. Do all the fame, you know I stay true. Pray my niggas stay free. Made a few mistakes, but this ain't where I wanna be. Before I'm jet by 12, pulling 12 on my feet. Tell my niggas I need you. Stay up, I know these times ain't true. Real life, yeah. What's free? Fed investigations heard they plotting like I track. 20 million cash, they know I got that up for rap. Maybe it's the Michael Rubens or the Robert Krafts. Or the billionaire from Marcy in the way they got my back. See how I prevailed and now they try to knock me back. Lock me in the cell for all them nights and I won't snack. 250 a show and they still think I'm selling crack. When you bring my name up to the judge, you tell them facts. Tell them how we funding all these kids to go to college. Tell them how we ceasing all these wars, stopping violence. Trying to fix the system in the way that they designed it. Me silence. Oh, say you can see. I don't feel like I'm free. Locked down in my cell, shackled from ankle to feet. Judge banging that gavel turned me to slave from. They want me silence.
You gotta run that back.
Oh, say you can see. I don't feel like I'm free. Locked down in my cell, shackled from ankle to feet. Judge banging that gavel turned me to slave from a king. Another day in the big. I gotta hang from a string, just for popping a willy. My people monster the city, from a cell to a chopper, view from the top of the city. You can tell how we rockin' soon as I pop up. We litty poppin' like Bad Boy in 94. Big poppin' and Diddy and niggas counting me out. Like my account ain't busy, that's 5,000,020. Sit up and count till I'm busy. Fear 500,000, honey running in sizzy. As we be feeling
rich, niggas thought he was gone, man.
Like, what's free?
Hey, they thought Meek was done, bro. I gonna say they. We, me,
I didn't.
Done, bro.
I didn't.
I've been right.
I didn't think he lost the battle with Drake. I definitely think he lost the battle.
He did lose the battle.
I didn't think he was done after that.
Did I think he? Did I think he was?
I didn't think he declined because yes. He was too. I said this before. He's a reality rapper.
Take it.
He's a reality rapper. When you are a reality rapper, you are always and will be relevant. You feel me? Everything you say will be felt. J. Cole, Kendrick Lamar, Big Crit.
So Meek's back in that top tier.
Nipsey. When you speak reality in your raps, Boosie.
There's always a lane.
You're always going to be felt.
That's timeless. Like, so that's much. How you make timeless
only,
music.
And that's not really what I meant. I really want to count Meek out, but more so the fact of, like, it's only so much room. And once you get it, it's real easy to lose it, bro.
Bro, when you figure it out, bro, it's
who,
all...
Who knew he'd figure it out?
When you figure it out. I'm saying when you especially, figure it out. Bro, It's room for everybody.
Right. Luckily, he's in an era where these niggas is kind of figuring it out. But now they collaborate and work with each other.
I think it was more, I feel what you're saying on an internal level with Meek. Like, I think the public perception is what it is. Like,
that's what I'm saying.
You know what I'm saying?
I didn't think they would accept Meek the way they did after Drake, you know?
Yeah, time heals all.
Post Drake beat.
Time heals all. I knew it was going to be just a matter of time before he got back to where he was at. He did take a hit, but I think the biggest battle was internally for Meek. Yeah. I think he counted himself out a while after that beef.
Look, after the him and Drake situation.
I think the music took a hit up until he put out the mixtape he put out when he was with Nicki. I forget the one with Liddy again on it and the Chains verse and
Nicki,
all that shit.
Nicki was good at battling him. I mean, and I'm
I think at the time
the person,
I think at the time she was good. I think she was good at the time. I think she held him down through
and
the situation.
And the way he handled it after.
But I think Meek had to internally, I'm speaking as a writer and as an artist, like, I think he had to work through some things with his pen and with his spirit. Yeah. And I think he's worked through that shit. The last album
was there, Meek's but always, but his public perception Meek's, wasn't there Meek's for the last
pen,
album.
Meek's pen's always been underrated, though.
Yeah. No, I'm not saying it's underrated. I'm saying him with him. Okay. As a writer, internally, yeah, as a writer, saying. It's about is the first step is with you. Like, do you think this shit's classic?
Yeah.
Like, are you second guessing yourself? And I feel like in the music, I could hear him. I could. It's almost like he was battling himself for a long time, and he was trying to prove to himself that yo, I'm still that nigga. I still got it. Fuck these niggas. Fuck everybody that don't fuck with me no more. And I think it took a toll, man. I mean, mental health is a thing. You can't go through that shit and get the backlash in the public. Kind of crucifixion that happened and not that should not leak into your psyche. So I think he had to work through that shit on his own, and I think he's back now, man. Proud of that nigga for that shit. A lot of that shit, I think his album kind of painted a picture of what he was going through while he was in jail.
Hey, and that's what's dope about him, and that's what I think he finally mastered coming up, though. Like, that's where I see the most development in him as an artist, is because he's harnessed that ability, the ability to tell a story and paint a picture, because...
He's always had that.
What I thought
Tony
about...
Tony's story was classic.
That's what I was going to mention when I said his pen was underrated. Tony's story. Like, his ability to paint a picture, and, like, he's figured out how to take that and the mainstream and the trap music and the Philly
and
shit,
and come
you
from
know?
His perspective from what he's been. I think he's lived and he's experienced some things.
Now he's incorporating the judicial system and all that.
Yeah, like, and his perspective is key right now because he's really
got a real voice.
He's telling a story because Kendrick is telling it, but he's telling it from a third person. Right? Cole is telling the story, but they're telling it from a third person.
Exactly.
Meek is telling it from a first person. From a street nigga, this is what the fuck I'm thinking, this is what I'm going through, and he's saying it in a way that's relatable to the masses.
I heard J. Cole was fake woke.
Can I
heard that before?
Fuck no.
Can I quote?
I heard, can I quote
a line?
Said that, said Chance Rapper was fake
can
woke.
I quote a line?
No, stop. All right, hold that. Go ahead.
Okay. They told Cap, stand up. If you want to play for a team, and all his teammates ain't say a thing. As deep as fuck.
Me say that? A couple of his teammates
trauma,
was with him.
I was on trauma.
That was a hard... That was a hell of a way to start an album.
He said...
That's when I heard that. I said, okay, I know what he's on this album.
He said, and ain't no one say a thing. Hey, that's how much control they got.
Oh, yeah. Are we going to get into the...
That shit was crazy.
Dude asked from the... From what team was he on? He got the domestic violence charge. I think he's been arrested 3 times in the past year for domestic violence. Ooh. They cut him
recently? For the 49ers.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. They cut him from the 49ers. And the Redskins picked this nigga up.
Yep.
But he's on the commissioner's exempt list, so he can't play. But they signed him, so if he gets through the shit or whenever he gets through the shit, he's going to have a job in the NFL. And it's like, yo, what the fuck? So, y'all going to pick this nigga up? Beat his girlfriend or whatever?
He used to play for Philly. He's what's his name's brother. He's a dude that plays for Harris Brother.
I'm going to look that shit up while I'm listening to Jay Verse. Let's get back into this Jay Verse.
Yeah.
Y'all ready? Let's get into this.
In the land of the free where the blacks enslaved, 3/5 of a man, I believe, is the phrase. I'm 50% of Duce and it's dead free, yeah? 100% of Ace of Spades, worth half a beat, boom. Rock Nation, half of that, that's my piece. 100% of title to bust it up with my cheese. Smokes, my niggas won't ever work together. You run a checker, but they never give you leverage. No red hat, though Michael and Prince, me and Ye. They separate you when you got Michael and Prince's DNA. I ain't one of these house niggas you bought. My house like a resort. My house bigger than yours, my spot. Come on, man. My route better, of course. We started without food in our mouth. They gave us pork and pig intestines. Shit you discarded that we ingested. We made the project away. You came back, reinvested, and gentrified it. Took niggas sense of pride, now how that's free. And them people stole a song and hit niggas with 360s. I ain't got a billion streams, got $1 billion. Inflating numbers like we both be happy about this. We was praising Billboard, but we were young. Now I look at Billboard like, is you dumb? To this day, grandma afraid what I might say. They gonna have to kill me, grandmama, I'm not their slave. Check out the bazaar. Rapping style used by me. The HOV, look at my hair free. Carefree. Niggas ain't nair free. Enjoy your chains. What's your employer name with the hairpiece? I survived a hood, can't no shot come rob me. My account's so good, I'm practically living tax free. Factory, that's me. Sold drugs, got away, scot free. That's a CCE copy. Guilt free. steal me and expect me to not feel away. To this day, USA, y'all kill me. Sucker free, no shucking me. I don't jive turkey. Say happy Thanksgiving shit sound like a murder to me. Smoke free.
That nigga. All right.
All of y'all calling out toll free. Label rob you for millions, yet you want to put a hole in me. Sugar free, season, but I'm so free. You lay a hand on hold my shooter, shoot for free. I promise World War III. Send an order through a hands free. Kill you in 24 hours or shorter. You can't ignore the hand speed. On guard, it's off the head. This improv, but it's no comedy. Sign I fail? Hell no.
If Jay's not at least in your top 10 of all time, I don't trust your music ear. Like, I don't trust it.
Yeah, man. That's facts.
And the more, the older it seems like this nigga gets, the more refined this nigga's pen gets, fam. Like, I don't see how you can not.
You don't have a pen, Jay.
And exactly. He don't even write in the traditional sense. That's just overrated, though. But whatever. Are we gonna deep dive into this? Is it the J verse? How y'all feel about this shit?
It was fire.
Huh? We gonna talk about Conscious J?
I like it. I mean, Conscious J is Conscious J. I mean, it's fire still.
I mean, I like that he's taking his platform. He got the biggest platform, so it's nice that he talks about it.
You know what?
I like it. He got the platform. You
think he should rather write a book soon?
He got one.
Oh, you do?
Decoded. Ever heard about that book, Decoded?
Oh.
He broke down his like most famous and personal verses and shit.
Nah, I'm not trying to hear that shit. I'm trying to
get a book about what?
A blueprint book, nigga. The plan. He said, I ain't got a billion streams. I got $1 billion. He's trying to tell you something there. But he's hiding it behind something. You feel me? Mm-hmm. And it's like he's telling you, but what is he telling you? Nothing but us to make assumptions to stuff. So I'm thinking, nigga, make a book, tell somebody the game.
Mm-hmm. Watch the table. I think he started on 444. I think his platform and what he's trying to give to the people and what he's trying to teach them. I think he's been explicit in that. 444 was all about ownership. It was all about black empowerment, black economics, collective economics. You know what I'm saying? Don't be a slave. It was all about that shit. So I think this was just
I think a book will work. I think he'll sell a lot.
Niggas gonna listen to that shit, bro.
Niggas don't read.
That's what I'm saying.
Don't read. We don't need a book. You're using a great platform. Everybody listens to music.
But what did you understand?
I'm not saying it's a bad idea.
No, I'm saying what are you understanding?
It's a great platform.
What are you understanding? I'm not saying it's not a great platform. I'm saying how is he doing it? Is it working?
I'm just saying we got two different you're making two different points.
What is your point?
I'm talking about Conscious J and you talking about his business plan.
No, I'm not talking about his business.
You're talking about the blueprint, right?
He asked
about Conscious J.
Yeah.
He's using a great platform to be conscious. You're saying write a book with the platform. With a deeper sense of understanding.
Because he's not. What are you understanding in his conscience? What are you understanding? Like I just said,
black ownership in 444.
No, I'm talking about this last verse you was talking about. So what are you understanding? Like what are you acknowledging?
I take the quote that you just said. I got a billion dollars. Not yeah. A billion
what
streams.
Does that mean?
I put my money somewhere else. I focused on the money and not the music. I guess. Everybody interprets it a different way. Well, how'd you
That's
take it?
I'm taking it as, what do you mean?
Take it how you want to. Everybody's gonna take it differently. You're an audience. There's a lot of niggas in the audience. A lot of perspectives in the audience.
So is
everybody on the table gonna have a phrase?
I'm up on my feet. Told my niggas I need you.
Break it down.
I know these times ain't true. Real life was free.
In the land of the free where the blacks enslave. 3/5 of a man, I believe, is the phrase.
He's starting off teaching.
Saying what? Explain. Now you gotta explain. If you gonna pause and do that? Explain every rip.
Is that the Missouri Compromise?
The 3/5 law.
3/5 compromise.
The
right?
No. The 3/5 law was literally. It wasn't even a law. It was just the way that they view. So. Back in
slave owners
back
had
when,
a vote, but you also got an additional.
It was
vote
their
for
way.
Slave, but you got only 3/5.
They couldn't count slaves as free people, right? Because if they counted them as a whole free person.
then the power to vote would take effect. And so what they did was they classified black people, black enslaved people at the time, as 3/5 of a man, right? And so when it comes to the electoral college, they was able to, you know what I'm saying, not have the balance of power kind of shift to the South or whatever, because if they counted every person as a man, then the South is going to, their policies or whatever they want to do is going to be easy, right? And so the 3/5 of a man clause was what they did to classify, so they really viewed black people as not a whole person in the eyes of the law and whatever.
Okay, so what is he doing? What is he doing? So what is he doing in that bar right there? What is he saying?
I guess he's teaching, but it's on you to be the student and go look it up. Bro, it's only so much as I can do.
I know what he's doing, bro. I know what
Jay. What are you looking for?
I'm looking for the nigga B, because these niggas ain't understanding him. If we got to sit here and talk about conscious Jay-Z.
Jay-Z came along.
Nigga, he came way back, right? Way back before 444. He been conscious ever since Def Jam, ever since he left, ever since Rockefeller was over, it was done being. That was done.
Truthfully, I want to rhyme like Common Sense, but I did 5 mil. I ain't been rhyming like Common Sense. When your sense got that much in common and you been rhyming since, fuck perception of what when I'm going up against most of the rappers was so most important. And I can't help the poor if I'm one of them, so I got rich and gave back. To me, that's the win-win. He been telling y'all niggas this. That was 05.
It's on you to be the student, man.
Now he's at the point where he can really kind of talk about some shit. And Jay's always been a conscious person, even on Reasonable Doubt. The song The Evils is one of the most socially conscious songs
ever. I'm saying...
Can I Live is one of the most socially conscious songs ever.
You talk, that's what I'm saying. That's just why I'm saying. You talking about conscious Jay-Z, like, that's just like a phrase of him. Like, nigga's always been conscious. Nigga,
that's what you're saying.
Yeah, I agree. So it's like, nigga, I think, nigga, either he has to, nigga, dumb it down, mm-hmm. or, nigga, explain it thoroughly. Nigga, just like, stop saying...
I think this shit is pretty cut and dry.
All right, keep going.
So he's painting a picture on what's exactly.
So he's saying they still think.
50% of Deuce saying is debt free. Yeah, 100% of Ace of Spades worth half a B.
Now he's telling you what the fuck he did. Like, I did it. I freed myself.
See, I'm 50% owner. I did it. Deuce. And 100% Ace of Spades. So what is he explaining?
How it's what he's been saying. I did it. He's using, he painted a picture on black people are enslaved, 3/5 of a man. We still not free in America, but I did it. Like, I got it.
I know, but explain that, because a lot of people don't know what the Deuce and Ace of Spades. A lot of people don't know Ace
Deuce of Spades. Deuce is Jay-Z's alcohol. They've been in the spirits for a minute, right, at Rockefeller.
A lot of people know about Deuce, but Ace of Spades.
Yeah, Ace of Spades is a champagne. It's another spirit. He owns 100% of Ace of Spades.
So what's that's the his company. Of Ace of Spades? Because I don't think a lot of people be drinking Ace of Spades now. I think, you know, not hip. You know, some people are drinking.
What's crazy is that
not niggas here.
I endorse.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah.
You put my face on it. I endorse Deuce. So that's how you get the black community. Ace of Spades, more expensive. It's my company, so I'm going to sell to them, though. I'm going to get the dollar there. So you to be the student, bro.
Yeah. I think this, he's just telling this
Ace
one.
Ace of Spades was the liquor that him and Damon Dash used to have in all their videos.
The backstory on Ace of Spades.
That's what I was saying.
So at first they was always pushing Cristal. They were trying to shout out Cristal in the songs and the videos and all of that. And then I think the owner of Cristal.
They didn't like it, right?
The owner of Cristal came out just like Tommy Hilfiger, just like a bunch of people that own corporations and companies and products. They came out and said, look, hip-hop and black people are fucking up my drink. I didn't make it for them. They got all these niggas drinking this shit. They saying it in hip-hop songs. This is not what the fuck I meant. It's supposed to be a high-class drink. Stop, nigga. And so they said, okay, fuck you. So then they stopped pumping that shit. They realized the power of their voice and the power of marketing, the power that hip-hop has when it comes to marketing a product. He realized that shit early, and so they opened their own shit, Ace of Spades. I think initially they partnered, and now he owns 100% of it. Yeah, and so then a few years down the line, Duce. Because I think Hennessy kind of came out and was saying the same thing, which is why the Henny Palooza turned into Duce Palooza, so on and so forth.
What'd you say? Oh, no, I was going to say Nas got some partnership, an endorsement with Hennessy.
Yeah, I support Nas, though. Get your money, bro.
In the title to bust it up with my jeans, smokes my niggas won't ever work together. You run a checker, but they never give you leverage. No red hat, no Michael.
I'm gonna need I need an explanation on that.
My niggas never work together. That's what he said.
Mm-hmm. So niggas never work together. They let you run a checkup, but don't give you leverage. Which is again the part of the ways that they keep black people just not as owners, right? They so we're never a partner. We're always the endorsement. So think of endorsements when it comes to a product. Since we're on this product shit, athletes, right? They don't have ownership, and this is what Big Baller Brand was kind of getting at when he was doing his thing. Is we're never partners, right? We're always the commodity. We're always the face, but they give us that bag, they give us that percentage just to,
just to run the checkup,
the product. They give you that shit so you get your little numbers up, you get a couple bands or whatever, but you don't. It's pennies compared to how much the company and the corp or the product is making off of your likeness. And so people would rather, a lot of artists and athletes will rather go for that small bag, that quick money. Just give me that endorsement real quick, then playing the long game like LeVar Ball is doing and saying, no, we're not gonna settle for this little bag. We're not gonna shuck and jive. We're not coming in as just the endorsement. We want in. Like, we want a percentage. We want ownership. And so
something like he's doing with Puma.
Who's doing with Puma?
Jay-Z. Young Jay-Z.
He got a deal with Puma now.
Yeah, that's how all those NBA players are going to Puma. DeMarcus Cousins.
Yeah. It probably is.
Scary Terry.
I mean, just based on his history as an investor and a businessman, he's definitely coming in as a partner and an owner. I mean, that's what they did with Def Jam. You know what I'm saying? With Rockefeller.
He's always.
They was never signed to Def Jam. They was partners. Mm-hmm. But yeah, so that's where he's getting at with that. All right, now let's get into this Kanye line.
All right.
Because people really have the wrong idea about what the fuck is going on in this line. So let's dispel all these fucking rumors and shit.
Nation, half of that, that's my piece. 100% the title to bust it up with my cheese. Smokes, my niggas won't ever work together. You run a checker, but they never give you leverage. No red hat, don't Michael and Prince me and yay. They separate you when you got Michael and Prince's DNA. I ain't one of these house niggas you bought. My house like a resort. My house bigger than yours, my spot.
Come on, man.
My route better, of course. We started without food in our mouth. They gave us pork and pig intestines. Shit, you.
A lot of people are taking that line as he's talking to Kanye because he said don't red hat, right? And I'm taking red hat as the Make America Great Again hat, right? Red hat, don't Michael and Prince me and yay. Because when Michael and Prince was coming up in their times, people tried to, they tried to make it so they was in competition with each other.
Yep.
I think their relationship was, I think they had a friendship, they had a relationship, but I think eventually, like, all of the noise kind of got in the way of them.
It was because Michael Jackson asked him to be in this video.
Mm-hmm.
Bad. And, you know, if you know the video, Wesley Snipes was the friend that was the bad friend that wanted to, you know, get into altercation with Michael Jackson. That was supposed to be Prince.
Mm.
And Prince was denied doing it. He said, no, I'm not.
He didn't want to?
Yeah, he didn't want to do it. He was like, he told him no. And he said it in an interview. He said, especially if it's a song called Bad. I'm not coming in over. Ain't nothing bad about it. And then there was the separation.
Fuck him, Tito. Well, fuck him then, Tito.
Hey, Prince was talking to Shalimar or Alexander O'Neal. Fuck that nigga. Or Morris Day. Prince and Morris Day. It's my fuck Michael.
Prince is the North Side.
I told you fuck Michael. That's why you should have put me on. Fuck him. That's the old fuck with them.
Morris Day's a real nigga, man. Shout out to Morris Day, wherever you at. He's still alive.
Hell yeah.
Legend. So the Prince line. So, Red Hat, Make America Great Again. So, this is all about Trump. This is where he's talking about Trump now.
Trump don't separate me and Ye, right? They don't Michael and Prince me and Ye. And then after that, now he's going in on Trump. So all of the lines, the braggadocious lines about my whip bigger, my crib, you know what I'm saying? My spouse don't even, when do I get into that? It's Beyonce, you know what I'm saying? So all of that is for, all of that is for Trump. It's not for Kanye. He's not talking about Kim. It's all for Trump. Because why would he first say, why would he preface all of that shit by saying, don't separate me and Ye? Like, it doesn't, it doesn't logically make sense. He's talking about Trump in that.
Right. Okay, let it go. No, hold on, wait. Bring it back a little bit. Because he said some shit about some pork. And I want to hear that. I want an explanation on that shit, too. Mm.
The result, my house bigger than yours, my spot. Come on, man. My route better, of course. We started without food in our mouth. They gave us pork and pig intestines. Shit you discarded that we ingested. We made the project the way you came back, reinvested in shit.
Couple things. I mean, I think he's historically, he's historically accurate. And this is the dope thing about this, the mature, the older Jay-Z, is that he's able to really, he's able to teach in his music now, as well as be entertaining, which is a skill and art form in itself. So he's talking about the history of enslaved black people on the plantations. That we got the seconds, we got the scraps of everything.
Eating chitlins.
Yeah. You want to talk to the chitlin eaters? Go ahead, bro, let them know. They don't give a fuck, bro.
Shit nasty, man.
They don't care.
Don't eat that shit.
They don't give a fuck. People that eat that shit don't give a fuck about what you, what they don't care, nigga.
They don't.
You can't care to eat some shit, nigga.
They gotta come out. A white person gotta come out and say, that's why all the slaves eat chitlins.
They not, they don't care.
I know my mom will stop.
He'll be like, yup.
My mom and my daddy gonna stop. They gonna be like,
we used to give them right to them. Serve it right up.
We used to look at him like, I can't believe these niggas are eating this shit. Dropped, like,
yeah. All the chillin'
Trump, eating, look Trump at, grandmama.
All the people that don't
Trump
eat chillin'
on CNN saying that shit.
We used to give
it all the Trump and look at all the chillin' eaters. All the chillin' eaters are gonna be looked down on by all the black people that didn't eat. She's like, look, I told you, nasty field nigga. Hey, that's what they gonna be on.
I can't
on,
believe
man.
You niggas is really eating this shit.
Oh my
god. God damn.
Go ahead.
Alright, but yeah, and then the second half of that was now he's getting into gentrification and the history of now we y'all confined us to this space, this inner city, this urban area, the ghetto, whatever you wanna call it. And we made it something popular, right? Like, you know what I'm saying? We made it a livable thing, we made it so we had fun in it, and now y'all look at it because of the popularity and the marketability of hip hop. Now you looking at these neighborhoods like, oh, now y'all want to live there, and now you're coming back to buy it up and pushing everybody out. So again, he's keen, and he knows what the fuck is going on right now. Unlike, you know what I'm saying, a lot of people were saying about Eminem and a few other of the legends that's in the game, like they had her out of touch. Jay's very much so has his finger on the pulse of pop culture and the political and social climate of the country right now. I'll just finish this up.
Friday, some niggas sense of pride, now how that's free. And them people stole the song and hit niggas with 360s. I ain't got $1 billion, got $1 billion. Inflating numbers like we po' be happy about this. We was praising Billboard, but we were young. Now I look at Billboard like, is you dumb? To this day, grandma afraid what I might say. They gonna have to kill me, grandmama, I'm not their slave. Check out the bazaar, rapping style used by me. The HOV, look at my hair free, carefree. Niggas ain't nair free, enjoy your chains. What's your employer name with the hair piece? I survived a hood, can't no shot come rob me. My account's so good, I'm practically living tax free. Factory, that's me. Sold drugs, got away, scot free. That's a CCE copy. Guilt free, steal me, and expect me to not feel away. To this day, USA, y'all kill me. Sucker free, no shucking me. I don't jive turkey. Say happy Thanksgiving, shit sound like a murder to me. Smoke free, all of y'all calling out toll free. Label rob you for millions, yet you wanna put a hole in me. Sugar free, season, but I'm salt free. You lay a hand on hold my shooter, shoot for free. I promise World War III. Send an order through a hand speed. Kill you in 24 hours or shorter, you can't ignore the hand speed. Oh God, it's off the head, this improv, but it's no comedy. Sign I fail? Hell no.
Yeah, man.
Goat shit.
It's goat shit for real.
There's a lot of flex in that last part, last piece of the verse. But again, he was talking about a lot of shit. He talked about artists signing deals and how that's another form of slavery and all of this shit, man. He's very, very much so in touch with what's going on, and he's speaking all facts on this shit for sure.
All right, man. Anything else with this Meek shit?
Man, Meek did a great job, man. That's what I'm hearing. I'm gonna listen to it through the weekend.
Did he snatch album of the year, Keem? That's what people were saying.
It's early for that, man. You know how people got album of the year.
December. He got album of the year already.
It's a good time to put an album out because you're gonna.
It's December.
Huh? They're saying he snatched it.
So he took it from Drake. He took it from...
I'm naming all the people that dropped albums.
Okay, I thought you were saying Drake had the album.
He took it from Travis. He took it from J. Cole. He took it from J. Rock. He took it from...
Nah. So now the question is, man, who's your prediction? Who do y'all think had?
I gotta go look it up.
No, man.
You named a lot of people that dropped albums.
What's your favorite? What you listen to a lot this year?
What's your personal favorite album of the year? What's your personal favorite top album of the year? Maybe give us three. All of those? Give us three of them. I mean, whatever you listen to, nigga.
That's what I'm saying. I gotta look it up. Because it's a lot of albums.
What you been listening to?
Did What's the Name come out this year?
Who?
Tyler the Creator.
No, he didn't drop this shit. He dropped it last year.
He's right, though, because I definitely... That was a good album. I do got to go on my phone and look. I'm going to give it to you. I'm going to tell you, though.
All right, well, you go ahead, then. Go first. Let me chill. You got some? Go ahead.
I got personal favorite albums this year.
Go ahead. Get your top three.
They're definitely not going to be mainstream albums. Like, okay, nobody else is going to give a fuck.
Give me your top three. Yeah.
Top three albums of this year?
Yeah.
J-Rock.
Okay.
Saba.
Saga?
Saba. S-A-B-A.
Oh, Saba.
Saba.
What song he got? Or she got? Or...
It's a dude. All right, he's a Chicago artist. So he's kind of from the Chance family tree.
Oh, okay. Yeah, but what are you talking about now?
He had an album called Care For Me. Or Care.
Yeah. That bangs.
One of the best albums out this year. Mm-hmm. For sure. Also think Nipsey has one of the best albums that came out this year. Yeah.
What's the album called? Victory Lap?
Mm-hmm.
That came out this year.
Top of the year, yeah.
Okay, first quarter. Hold on, I'm going to look it up.
Nipsey's album was definitely one of the hardest albums out this year. Cole is up there, right? I know Chance didn't drop an album, but I mean, all the singles that he's dropped this year is Cole. Put it together. I don't think Travis Scott had one of the top albums of the year. Not that I didn't like it, I just don't think it's one of the best albums out.
All
right, Travis is cool. He's talented, but I'm not 10 toes in like a lot of people are with Travis. Mm-hmm. I get it though. Definitely. I would say them some of my top albums. Buddy also put out an album this year that I think is really, really dope. Under the Radar. Buddy's another West Coast artist. He actually had a few songs. He's on Nipsey's album, and he put an album out this year.
Yep. Mm-hmm. 2018, February
16th.
Mm-hmm.
First quarter. Too bad y'all only ended in a battle rap like that, man. We could talk about
what's up. I've been watching.
We talk about Battle of the Year or something like that. But I'm not
trying to hear that. This shit been getting weak, man. These
Did y'all see the Reed Dollars and T-Rex?
My God.
That nigga Reed
Thursday.
Nigga Reed
had to get
bodied. That nigga,
T-Rex came for the check.
You know why he came? That's crazy.
T-Rex came.
T-Rex, get the fuck out of here with that bullshit, nigga. When you come for the check,
T-Rex came.
Your legacy's on the line, nigga.
You don't give a fuck about the legacy.
He better.
He know he got all the.
I already beat him.
I already said that last battle, nigga. You bite, nigga. Nah, man. That was a... I like the comeback battle. This is why I like the Arsenal and New Jersey twerk.
I'm talking about
I like that battle.
I'm talking about Tay Rock versus Goods.
I didn't see that one.
Who you said? Who won? Who won?
When was it? When did it drop?
That was Battle of the Year to me.
Did that drop this year? Yeah, it did drop this year.
Earlier this year. I've probably seen that show crib.
Yeah, see, that's why I said we can't talk about this shit, man. Niggas ain't really in this shit.
Niggas in it, bro. I've been watching. Yeah. Who you think? Goods. This nigga's a Charlie Goods like it, so he's
Charlie Clips. Yeah.
Oh, see, that's like
really what Rock was. Be flaming, though.
But Rock was off that day. He wasn't really kicking because he was telling off, him. Man. He wasn't telling.
Every time somebody compete with Rock, they be like, oh, he was off that day. No, nigga. Some niggas that Gumbar shit don't work with. Like Calico, struggled with Calico, nigga.
I fuck with Tay Rock, man. Tay Rock's cold.
Man. Yeah, he is.
That's why I need to. Calico need to come pop
grudge
out.
Grudge match.
Calico retired now.
K-Shine versus Tay Rock.
That nigga waiting for the bag.
That's the grudge match. They need to do that.
They already did.
The rematch.
You want another one?
Yeah.
Man, them niggas gonna fight for sure this time.
Man, all that energy, man. You know they gonna both be on their A-game.
They got
to both
be.
Gonna be on their A-game.
Because them niggas have real life hate for each other. Man. Like, this shit ain't really no battle shit.
Yeah, Tay Rock locked in and K-Shine locked in.
What else did I see? So I seen them two battles. I watched. I was going back to watch. I watched the Loaded Lux and Murder Mook, the first battle when it was like 8 rounds. When the shit was hella unorganized, I went back that far, like 8 years ago when they battled in the store. Remember they was in that clothing store, nigga.
When Lux won.
Well, Lux bodied that nigga.
Yeah, bro.
God damn.
Old, them super old ones.
That's when them niggas used Mook to just versus, go back and
Mook
forth.
Mook versus Sirius Jones.
Remember Sirius Jones?
Hey, that LA, nigga used to LA just down. Showed me this nigga Mellow Ball. Mellow Ball, it got these niggas scared, fam.
He's hooping right now.
Oh, why, nigga? Why didn't want to play him?
He's hooping. Oh, yeah. Teams is fourth. Like, they're refusing to
I
play.
Just hope, I hope they let him go play college.
They will. He's eligible still.
Yeah. They're letting people go get drafted,
Coach,
play for
Coach
the.
K said, "Come on, boy."
And let them come back.
Come on, boy.
And I tried to tell niggas he was gonna be the coldest ball brother.
He ain't the coldest.
He's definitely the coldest.
Jello,
I'm the coldest.
Jello's not the fucking coldest.
I'm the coldest
ball brother.
Jello's the coldest, bro.
You the half brother, huh? They half brother Sean Ball.
I'm outside the family. I ain't get that pass down, that O at the end. I ain't get that L on me. I ain't get none of that, bro.
Oh, the Tay Rock and Goods dropped a month ago. No, I definitely didn't see that one. No, I didn't see that one. DNA and O Red. I'm not really interested in that one. That's only 30 minutes anyways.
Who else is who's a cold new nigga, y'all? Like, T-Top wrong.
Yeah. A cold new nigga, you said?
Rum Nitty. The Rum West. Nitty,
cool. I fuck with
The West. B Dot. Nigga Ichigadi.
I fuck with Briz.
Ichigadi's nice.
Briz Rothstein.
He just got good.
Y'all fuck with Briz.
It's when niggas he like niggas that
Briz
niggas.
Fell off, dude.
Already?
Yeah. Briz versus Charlie was rough.
Briz versus DNA was rough. I mean, versus O-Red was rough. Yeah, bro, he struggles.
But he been missing out. He don't know. He don't know shit.
He's cool, though.
He don't know shit. He's been out. You know T-Top ain't rap since. No, I was playing.
B-Dot, man. I need to see him on URL.
Yeah, I do, too. I definitely do, too.
He's not going back to URL.
Not based on his third verse, nigga.
No, hey.
This is the verse. Hell, no. He about to go back to his shit. I was happy to see Arsenal, man. I don't give a fuck what y'all niggas saying, fam. That was a good battle. Him and Jersey Twerk. It was Jersey and Jersey. Like, how could you not be like that?
Bro,
he bodied
him. If it wasn't a return battle,
he always does that.
Wasn't gonna kill him, fam.
I don't think it got nothing to do with him returning. Like we said, I think
it got something to do with.
I think he cared.
He got killed his exiting. His exiting.
Twerk.
He got killed leaving.
If he wasn't from Jersey. Look, say if New Jersey Twerk wasn't from Jersey,
right?
And it wasn't
Florida Twerk,
and it Florida Twerk, hey. But and Arse wasn't his return battle. It was just them two matching up. He don't beat him, bro. It was just overhyped. It was gas because he was his comeback battle, and it was the King of Jersey and all that.
It was the perfect storm of every. It had storylines, mm-hmm. nigga. That's what's entertaining, bro. That's what we like.
What was the storyline?
And he delivered.
That?
It was the Battle of Jersey. It was Arsenal's comeback.
Whoever said he was the king of Jersey?
In battle rap? Yeah. You don't gotta say it. Ooh, who else?
Ars is.
Yeah, that's what I'm
battle rap,
who
yeah.
else?
Whoever said New Jersey Twerk was?
That's what I'm saying. Well, he probably did.
I'm the king of Jersey.
He probably believed it.
I'm the king of Jersey. Ain't nobody worthy.
They're boring. They're boring. Harlem niggas always kill their ass.
Mm. That's what you fuck with.
They fuck with Harlem battle rappers. St. Louis always killing their ass,
man. They fuck with Harlem niggas, man.
That's what you fuck with.
Harlem nigga.
Hey, man.
From North Minneapolis.
Let's move into sports, man.
Let's go. What happened?
Move on to sports, man. A lot of shit is going on.
The Clippers are the first in the West conference right now. Coach.
Y'all think that shit real?
Look at the coach.
Y'all think it's real?
Y'all think that shit real?
Who's the coach?
It's fake news.
Who's the coach?
I don't know.
He's his man.
He said he don't know.
His man's.
He said he don't know.
He know who the coach is.
Hater. Hater.
It's his man's, bro.
He ain't Luke Walton, man.
So they gonna are they gonna be the number one seed at the end of the year? Nigga, turn that shit off, nigga.
Bron's coming, man.
Huh?
Bron creeping up on their ass, man. That's the scary part about it being
trying
first.
To tell you.
That's the scary part about being in first, fam. And man, with Bron being in the West now. But you also gotta realize that Steph is out too.
That is true. He is out.
So the Warriors ain't top notch like they should be. Who else? Harden was out.
Yeah, we talked about this.
You heard me? Harden was out.
He was.
Yeah, Harden was out for a minute. Melo came in fucking shit out.
I don't know, man. NBA season is looking real weird right now. Like, it's just not... It's like unpredictable right now. Like, nobody even... Who knew that the Clippers was going to be in the number one seed right now? Who knew that...
Sacramento in, like, top five?
Yeah, who knew they was going to be in the top five this year? Who knew... The Wolves is gonna
Nuggets
fall
are
off.
Number two.
No, I kind of knew
Thunder's four. They were they. That's not bad for them, I guess. Blazers is solid this year.
Yeah, I mean we knew that though.
They're great.
Who knew the Jazz was gonna fall off? Yeah, who knew the fucking Grizzlies was gonna? They signed Joakim Noah.
And then number six.
He had a terrible contract.
What about Kyle Korver going back to the Jazz?
Think it's gonna mean something? I mean, they gives him a shooter.
Yeah,
but I don't think they. I mean. Where's he gonna start? He gonna play 30
retire
minutes a game
and put his jersey in the rafters. That's all
in
he
Utah?
Wants. That's all he wants.
He gotta retire in Philly. Man.
I think he can.
Why get, Philly?
He can start it.
He could take some.
Never
take
made
some
the
pressure
playoffs
off
with Philly.
He could take some so. Pressure off of Joe Ingles.
He made the playoffs with.
Oh yeah, they do got Joe Ingles.
When Donovan that's Mitchell true. Comes, out, when Donovan Mitchell
he
plays
became
point,
a difference in.
Can't hear both
he became a difference in. What's his name in Utah? That's when he became a difference.
Kyle Korver.
Yeah,
he was always a shooter though.
You can move Mitchell to the point, put him at the two.
Hell yeah, man.
The Rockets is second to last.
I saw that coming.
That's crazy.
But the Lakers were.
No, you're talking about the playoff standings, top eight.
Yeah.
Out of the whole thing, it's 15 teams in each conference.
In the West.
In the West?
Yeah.
The Rockets are 14 out of 15. The Suns at 15.
Oh, so they tanking.
Who, the Rockets?
Yeah.
They're not going to be that low by the time.
I mean, maybe.
It's still early, bro.
They're going to try to make some trades when they're
Zion.
It's still really early.
It's, yeah, it's the battle to get Zion.
Them and Zion. Right. Stop playing.
Another Clint Capella. A smaller Clint Capella.
Bro,
he's
Zion
a fucking
what
is
he gonna do?
That's
what
so gonna, much. That's so disrespectful, nigga.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. But listen, what is he gonna do? He's any six. Look, I'm not hating because I like him. He's from Duke, and I'm not hating because I'm like him. I'm just mad at where y'all putting him, bro. I'm just mad at where y'all putting him at. All right.
Oh, so he can't get drafted in
not
the first round.
Rockets.
In the first round.
I'm not taking them to the Rockets.
You don't want them to go to the Rockets.
The last team is the Suns. I put them there. That's a better.
What's
fit
the first
than the
team
Rockets.
That you think he
Zion
fits?
The Suns.
The perfect team he fits in right now in the NBA.
I don't know, bro. Definitely a team where no other stars. He don't need to be playing for
look
no
at this
championship.
Man. Come on, man!
Round.
You can't even be like that.
Look at what that did for Kyrie. It gave you a chance to develop, man, to find your niche. He really don't know
everybody
what he's gonna
be.
Nobody.
Kyrie.
Nobody knows what he's gonna be.
Everybody
bro.
Can't be Kyrie, bro.
But I'm saying, as far as development wise, tell me what he's gonna be in the league. Nobody really knows.
Right.
So if you put him somewhere like where there's not high expectations, he gets the chance to just develop his game.
Why he can't develop when there are high expectations?
I'm not saying he can't.
He ain't developing.
He don't need to be.
Is he developing with your Duke team? Because there's high expectations on your Duke team.
A bad team would be the Rockets.
He's
a playoff team where he has to perform.
Why?
But he has to.
You don't want him in that situation.
Why? Why are you so scared?
Is he gonna perform?
Jason Tatum was in that situation.
That's your man. So you don't want him to go there to play with big ball. You don't want him to go play with big teams, with heavy name teams.
Jason Tatum was in that situation.
You know what I'm saying?
Hey,
but Donovan Mitchell was in that situation.
Not originally.
Ben Simmons was in that situation.
And dude went down. Donovan Mitchell wasn't originally put in that situation. He was drafted number two late. Had mid number two round. He wasn't, these expectations.
Yeah, nobody really. Nobody knew.
They were in the playoffs last year. He was a pop out.
It's always one of those, though.
And not saying he can't be that, but going somewhere like the Rockets, I just don't think that's the fit.
But when they realized what he was,
that's when they traded Rodney Hood. Get the fuck out of here. We're going to ride this nigga. Pause.
Yeah. Great. And that's not saying you can't do that once you get him. I'm not saying you can't do that, bro. I'm not saying you can't do that once you get them. Oh man, we got our special guest arrived, man. Almost put a hole in the goddamn window. But nah, man. What else is going down, man? In the league, man. Well, who's running in the East, man? The Bucks. Is it
Toronto?
In the MVP argument, man. Who you giving it to? Antetokounmpo or Kawhi Leonard? All right, y'all, we're going to have to take a commercial break. You are live at 105 with Juice Man Sean Dot. These brothers don't know what to do when they do it.
Now pause it.
It could be natural.
All right, we back, man. We got to take a little break. Back in the building. Comment section podcast, Cool Keem here, Sean Dot LA. What's good?
We talking about NBA.
It's still the Lake Show. We gonna be all right.
I was telling these brothers during the commercial break, man, that the Lakers fans are just so blinded by the light, man. They're so blinded by LeBron. They think because they got LeBron that their ticket is just punched to the finals. I mean, I think y'all just gonna be
there. Punched to the playoffs.
Duh.
All right.
That's our expectations.
We're gonna win our first round matchup.
You don't even know who you're seven. That means you're gonna get who's two.
You think we're gonna be the seventh seed at the end of the year?
Okay, but I'm just saying, who are you gonna get?
We'll be top four at the end of the year.
Top four against potentially the Thunder.
If we play the fifth seed,
that's some grown ass men versus all them kids you got in one grown man.
I'll take the Lakers in that one.
Against the Thunder?
Yep.
It's not going to be no sweep. It's not going to be six. It's going to be seven.
That's cool. Bron knows what the fuck he's doing.
Nigga, in the first round, you want him to do it against Westbrook. In the first round, you want him to do it against Westbrook and Paul George. In the first round. So who is he going to get in the second? It doesn't even matter because by then he's tired. Seven against them? Seven in the first round in the East is not as bad as that.
That's when it's going to get real for LeBron. That's when he's going to realize what the fuck the Western Conference is really about.
Is
when the playoffs get here. Because you're playing elite after elite team every round.
This is different.
However, it's LeBron James. And he's going to take care of business. At least in the first round. I think we're going to get to the Western Conference Finals depending on where Golden State falls.
It depends on what card you draw. It depends on what you draw the first round. I don't think your ticket's punched in the first, bro.
Who are we not going to beat?
You're already...
Besides the Warriors, who do we not have a good chance to beat in the playoffs? Who do you trust that much to beat us in the playoffs?
Some veterans.
Who? Like you said, the Thunder? So you trust the Thunder to beat us?
Rockets.
You think the Rockets are going to be... Are the Rockets going to make the playoffs this year? Are the Rockets going to make the playoffs this year?
Was James Harden MVP last year?
Yeah.
All
right. It's this year.
Yeah. Yeah, they're going to make the playoffs.
You know, James always gets his numbers, but who's he guarding?
They're going to get the playoffs. He's back. He had like 35-17 last something like that last game, or one of them few
games. Yeah, on offense.
But that's their game.
Did you see offense. What the fuck Luka did to that nigga the other night?
Bro, his numbers.
Huh? Luka was busting his motherfucking ass the other night.
He's nice, bro. He's nice. It's crazy how like he's from overseas and he just like the perfect replacement for Dirk Nowitzki in that whole Dallas perfect. System. Like
Mark Cuban was like, nah, and I don't even, fuck and what even like, talking about. And
what's,
that nigga.
What's doper about it is like he's more innovative than Dirk Nowitzki. He's like this era of Dirk.
Oh yeah.
Like
he could dribble, playmaker, he could pass.
Man.
Score. He's nice, he not man. Scared of none of these niggas. I mean, he's been pro in he's Europe for like 5 years.
he's
yeah.
Bet.
He won a EuroLeague MVP last year. And he was MVP.
Bro.
Want some of this?
That's a lot of liquor you poured, bro.
Hey, don't worry about what's in my cup, nigga.
He's on a binge,
it's my cup.
He's on a binge. Substitute him for something, man.
Huh?
Substitute for something, man.
What you mean? I only do this shit on, binge, on recording days, bro.
Only on recording days.
Yeah, man. I gotta be entertaining for you niggas.
A few episodes. Never mind. Huh? But nothing, man. put your hard lemonade in there, man. With your passion fruit flavor, palm massage.
Nah, nigga, it's vanilla.
This nigga drink, it's vanilla.
Vanilla E&J and Mike's harder drinks. Lemonade, strawberry, pineapple.
Strawberry, pineapple.
It don't sound like they go together, and it probably smoothie. Don't go together. But
that's a smoothie.
I don't give a fuck. That's an alcohol smoothie. With shit. That shit. I want me to blend this shit with some ice in there?
I don't want none of that shit.
Y'all
want
no?
I'm good with my motherfucking Nantucky nectar.
Y'all sure don't want no drink, man.
Nantucky.
One of you niggas got to drink with me, bro.
Come on, man. Pull me up, man.
Oh, that's what I'm talking.
I just drink. No, I never. Man. I don't want none because I don't like vanilla liquor, bro.
You can't even taste the vanilla.
Nah, bro. I'm good, man. I'm good, bro. I'm good. I got my Northside Cub mac and cheese. Shout out to Northside Cub for having the best chicken in Minnesota, in Minneapolis.
That's a fact.
Yeah, man. The mac and cheese ain't all that, though.
The potatoes be on point with that Hawaiian bread.
Yeah, man. Yeah. JoJo's. Definitely a nice pickup if you're hungry sure. on lunch break.
Make you want to sing a Negro spiritual when you bite into it.
Man, you feel me? What is that? Who's that?
What's that? Come on, man. Talk, nigga. Let us know. Let the audience know what we're looking at.
Kendall Jenner got a boyfriend in high school that's hooping. He just showed me a video.
That's what you want to talk about?
Kendall Jenner got a boyfriend in high school that's getting
fucked. Pause. Wait a minute. All right. Let's talk about this shit. All right. So this was a couple days ago.
Make sure you read that shit, King, before you say that. Before you follow up what I just said.
All right. Kendall Jenner is a Cassius fan?
I don't know.
Cassius is a high school player in California.
He's number 3?
That's her boyfriend.
He's got the taco shoes.
Or is he number 4?
He's gonna get to the league.
He's number 3. Number 4 is Kenyon Martin's son.
That's Kenyon Martin's son?
Yeah.
Now his
the light skinned dude, the other light skinned dude, that's Scottie Pippen's son. So the dude
number 2?
Yeah. That's Scottie Pippen's son.
These niggas all play for the same
team. Yeah, that's the school future stepson. That's the school LeBron is trying to send his son.
Oh, in LA?
Yeah.
Is all the niggas seniors this year or what?
Nah, it's not a.
Are they the same age? Is he going to play with them?
That's middle school.
That's middle school?
This ain't no goddamn middle school game.
These niggas is not in middle school.
These niggas smoking out.
No goddamn middle school.
They A-grade. They A-grade.
Lying. These niggas not no A-grade. These niggas not no A-graders. The niggas they playing against might be A-graders.
Not in
A-grade. You see how these niggas playing? If these niggas in A-grade, then...
Them niggas' jerseys got HS on it. That means got that big ass scoreboard.
I'm finna do my research. Let me see, man.
This is Slam High School that you looking at, bro. This is a high school.
Like these niggas ain't in middle school. No, they was in middle school. I was gonna be scared for the league.
But if Bron's son's playing with them, that's definitely
next year.
Whew.
He's in eighth grade, right?
That's a chance to get real creative.
Yeah.
But
okay. Here's what happened. A few days ago, some news came out. Right, some news came out about former Lakers player Dwight Howard.
Oh my God, bro, you really want to get into this shit? Bro.
No, I don't. But I'm gonna tell the story about why we're not getting into it. So we're not getting into the story.
Reconsider.
But when I sent the news to the group chat and I posed the question, all I did was pose the question. I said, hey, are we gonna talk about Dwight Howard? And what happened after that, Sean?
What you mean, man? No, you ain't gonna be no. I ain't no co-defendant. Yeah, but you really talking about what you sent to the group chat, bro. I ain't probably nah. Ain't nobody even supposed to know we got a group chat. Why we not? Didn't finish your statement.
So
it's a statement now.
We didn't. So I just posed a question. Are we talking about Dwight Howard, or we gonna stay away from
watching them dry snitch on us right now? Go ahead, man.
Hey man, look.
Go ahead, man.
Look it.
Sean said, "Yeah, not too long. No, we can touch on it. Pause. But after that, you know what I'm saying, we're gonna move on."
Go ahead, man.
So LaVance chimed in. What do I do? This nigga didn't know. He was at work. So I sent the GIF of the cheerleaders from what's the movie with Adam Sandler in it? The football movie. Protect the McNuggets, what? Nigga.
Waterboy?
No.
Oh, shit. The longest yard? Terry Crews?
Yeah. So I sent him that shit. He said, what, nigga? I hope y'all not talking about that old-ass video of him grabbing dick. Nigga played for 3 teams after that.
How do
get
I
the get fuck out of here with that whole shit?
How do I get work done with this group chat, bro? Oh my god,
bro! I was getting
crying when he said that.
You know how
shit,
many times I had to go to the bathroom to write that?
Oh my god,
that's what was making me mad because I had to keep going to the bathroom.
Dog, I hope you're not talking about this old ass video of him grabbing dick. Nigga played for 3 teams after that. Fuck out of here with that old shit, nigga.
So I said, nigga, you gotta go on Twitter, bro, so you can stay relevant, bro. Some new shit that happened, nigga. So,
explain what happened, man.
So Sean told him about the story.
No, he
gave him the gist of what happened, and then this nigga LaVance said,
"But the crazy thing about that is I was on Twitter, fam, and a girl retweeted the tweet." This story got out because of the tweet that the so-called tranny or whatever, transvestite, transgender posted.
Uh-huh.
The girl retweeted it.
What girl?
I don't know.
Oh, girl. Some girl retweeted it? Because old girl ain't had no followers or something?
Damn, and then I seen the story, fam, and I started reading it, and it got bad, bro.
Got bad real quick.
It is real bad, man.
That's a fact.
Hopefully that ain't true. Hopefully, you know.
So this nigga LaVance chimed in. Y'all want to talk about all that gay shit?
We could lose all. He played it. Look, endorsements. Look at those spots.
All right, I'm done.
I ain't got nothing against gay.
Yo, man. Nothing against gay people, man.
He ain't on that.
I got some cousins that's gay. I love them. They're my cousins. You know what I'm saying?
I got some gay cousins.
I think I do, too. I don't know. God damn. All right, man. We off that. God damn. Y'all niggas is funny as fuck, bro. I'm crying right now.
Man, what y'all doing, man?
This nigga's nervous. He fishing it with shit. He on his phone.
Hey, you better edit all that shit out.
Yeah, man.
Hey, this nigga wanted to go ham for it.
Bro, I was just trying. Like, yeah, gay bitch. Bro, stay. I hate gay people.
I didn't say that. Nigga,
damn near that's what they gonna take it as.
Read it though.
So you damn near said you hate gay people?
He really made a statement on it.
I wasn't gonna say nothing to criminate. You didn't say nothing wrong, bro.
Alright, continue saying
it. It's just funny.
Let me hear it.
Huh?
Let me hear it then. Continue reading.
Oh shit. Alright. Cause you remember what you said.
He's gonna talk about all that.
Y'all wanna talk about all that much gay shit.
Oh yeah.
He played in ATL parentheses, gay city.
You're never gonna be able to go there before, bro. Chill. You ain't never gonna do that
for a year. I'm not interested in talking about that shit. He's not a champion. He's not an MVP. He's not shit to me. He just a motherfucking player.
I could have said something.
You thought something worse. So in my mind, when I'm reading this shit, I'm like, damn, this nigga. This nigga LA feels strongly about this shit. So I'm like, oh, I'm about to fuck with him now. He's bashing. It's over.
Yo, he got some feelings about Dwight Howard.
I said, why you want to avoid this shit so bad? Nigga, what's going on? You got something? All right, man, we off that, man. So we're not going to get it out, but I did want to tell that story because this shit was hilarious, nigga. I was downtown cracking the fuck up.
Man.
Oh, goddamn.
No, I'll tell you, you sent the picture with the shit on there.
What shit?
Somebody didn't somebody send a picture of a tranny and a transgender woman?
Wrong group chat, brother.
Yeah, I don't know what that is.
Not us, bro. Dang, somebody sent it to me.
I don't know who you changing things with, my nigga. But it ain't us. This is the wrong group chat.
I'm scrolling like, nah, all right, we ain't sent no picture, nigga. I don't know what that is.
Oh, my fucking God. Y'all niggas are stupid.
Got us mixed up with something on his Instagram, y'all.
Yeah, man. I just want to say, man, Dwight Howard, if you listening, bro, be you. Love who you love. Fuck who you want to fuck.
Be 100 about it. If that's going to be you, man.
I'm not surprised.
That's going to be you. Don't let nobody else be you.
Was it surprising when I heard? No, I wasn't surprised. Based on the way the nigga was playing in L.A., I knew something was going on.
He loved it in Atlanta, man.
He didn't want to leave.
He didn't want to leave.
He from Atlanta, too.
We'll go back.
But yeah.
He grabbed the nigga dick when he was playing for that
it's
one
crazy
team.
How
on every, camera he anything, did that shit. Hey, anything, so nobody grabs shit like that. That ain't yours.
He grabbed the fuck out that nigga's meat, bro.
Man, bro, we fist closed, nothing hit. Never hand.
My
grabbing.
Hand's not going in that area. What you like?
Hand
no.
grabbing. I'm talking about when we, you know, remember when we was in high school. Everybody hit each other in the nuts.
Nope.
Oh,
I didn't hit nobody in the nuts in high school.
Yeah, well, I went to North.
Y'all niggas, that's what y'all was doing?
Them niggas.
That was definitely like an 8th grade, 7th grade, probably like early high school.
Niggas used to open nuts.
Hell no, nah, man. After the first two times, shit was funny. After that, man, chill, bro.
Yeah, that shit, once the shit hurted worse, like when you felt it in your stomach a lot, you know?
Felt in your stomach.
Yeah, because ain't your nuts connected to your stomach?
Probably.
Because, nigga, every time I get hit in the nuts, every time I get hit in the nuts, my mother
feel like you're so
bro.
I get
well,
I'm with you.
You know, you got to lean back. You like,
You do feel like your stomach.
Bro, like that. Ain't got no time.
That's why I hate when women be playing like that, fam. I hit you in the nuts.
Yeah, I don't play those games, man. I never really liked those ones, man. Because that shit hurt, bro. I don't like getting hurt, bro. That's why I stopped playing football. Because the shit hurt, nigga. And I ain't like getting yelled at, bro. Don't yell at me, nigga. Fuck you.
You had your own schemes on the line you were trying to do. Don't correct me, nigga. I got it.
Yeah, I just didn't like, I don't know, maybe it was just I ain't shit, bro. I just didn't like getting yelled at and shit. That's why I stopped playing sports. Like, it got too serious for a nigga. Fuck y'all. Fuck you, coach.
This is an after school extracurricular activity.
I don't give a fuck about this shit. But niggas gave a fuck about this shit because they was trying to go pro. And I'm like, I don't really give a fuck that much. So I'm just going to go
the only
work.
Championship. Oh, never mind.
What?
My bad.
Not good.
I was going back to the Meek Mill.
Change the subject. I'll go back.
No, because you know it's called championships.
Yeah.
That was the only championship Philly had since.
Since the Eagles last year?
Yeah. But I'm talking about basketball because they had a picture of Meek Mill in the Sixers jersey. Mm. They ain't had a ring since Doc.
They might go this year.
Fuck out of here.
Absolutely.
Is it bad that I just wish the worst for Jimmy Butler?
Why?
Because the way he did Minnesota, bro.
He didn't do Minnesota nothing.
Yeah,
why are you talking about it?
How the fuck you going to get mad? This nigga said,
you want to do it or I'm going
to do it. Because he pissing me off talking about how he did. This is for everybody in Minnesota talking about Jimmy Butler, how he did us. It's not how he did us. He came here because y'all wanted him that damn bad. Did y'all or did y'all not?
Who?
Minnesota Timberwolves fans.
We didn't give a
who
fuck
wanted?
About him until
no,
we got him.
No. Tibbs wanted him.
No.
Who
wanted
him?
Stop playing.
Who was...
Nah, it's Tibbs.
Who wanted Tibbs?
Yeah.
They got Tibbs.
Time out.
Come on, man.
Who did y'all hear? Who did y'all hear caping for Jimmy Butler to come to Minnesota before the trade?
Look, bro.
When he got here, who knew it was...
Let me tell you what it's really about.
Who knew it was possible?
Look, let me tell you about what Jimmy Butler is, man. Jimmy Butler, fam, came up... I'm sorry, I keep hitting the table, man.
Yeah,
my fault. Hey, y'all, cool. if y'all be listening to this shit and y'all hear that mic be picking up, that'd be me, man.
We're going to put the noise reduction on there. I got the sauce, bro. It's all
shit,
good.
Man. But look, we got training coming up. But Jimmy Butler, bro, is top-notch all-star, fam. Right?
Mm-hmm.
He's been to the conference finals before. He used to winning, bro. Been in a winning organization. He was in the D-Rose era. He carried the Bulls before, right? He's used to being a number one player. He's a franchise player,
bro. He's not used to being a number one fucking player.
Why not?
Cause the nigga didn't get recruited to a. He didn't go to a blue.
He started out. If I'm not mistaken, he's a second round pick.
Yeah.
Or maybe a late first. But look, he's a defensive player, fam. Defensive stopper.
He's a worker.
He had to become a scorer, a 20 plus scorer a night
to stay in the game. Yeah, for sure. I'm with you.
And he did that.
Mm-hmm.
Peer out hard worker, bro. He's KG without the whole Minnesota story.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? It's just like getting KG. It's just like if we got a KG, right?
Yeah, I get you. I follow
Minnesota's
you.
Minnesota's never been able to keep players like that. Especially if I'm here and I'm playing with kids and we ain't winning and these niggas really ain't taking it serious that we losing. I'm used to being in the playoffs, Eastern Conference Finals. I see LeBron when I'm in June. When I'm playing in May, I'm playing against Bron. I'm playing against
Jimmy.
I'm in the playoffs.
Jimmy was going to the playoffs before he
Chicago.
A few years after when D Rose went down, and maybe a few years after D Rose went down, yeah, they were competitive.
They went to the playoffs when Dwayne Wade.
It's a different system, bro. You gotta look. He came into the NBA into a different system, into a different culture of
Jimmy
NBA.
Butler. My bad, bro. Jimmy Butler is a fucking star, bro. Let me tell you this. He's a fucking star. He's not no player that you give him money to make him a star. He earned it himself to become a star.
I'm with you.
He has the work ethic.
Blue collar player.
Blue collar motherfucking player.
Went to the Chicago Bulls. He's working out.
He did. You know what he did this summer? On purpose.
Compare theirs to the Wolves locker room now.
Listen. You know what he did on purpose this summer?
I can't hear both of y'all.
My bad.
What he did on purpose this past summer, mm-hmm. He bullshitted. He didn't work out.
Jimmy didn't?
No, he kicked it.
Okay.
You know?
Learn how to shoot.
He was kicking it and still did a little bit of basketball, but he didn't go 100. He said that. That's why I remember you said it took him a long time to come back after his injury.
He got hurt.
He didn't get back to working because he knew what the fuck these little niggas was doing already.
Mm.
Not fucking working.
They wasn't working all summer?
No, bro, he came back with all the motherfucking bench players and no-namers and whooped their ass in practice and talked all that shit. Said, nigga, I knew y'all niggas wasn't doing shit this summer. You weak-ass niggas. Look at your ugly ass. Dumb-ass braids, boy. I'll smack the fuck out of you, boy.
Hey, we're talking about Wiggins.
Bro, everybody. Wiggins, Towns, you soft.
And not cut this in.
And he said he guarded the all five positions.
Towns.
At that practice. So he wanted to guard everybody on purpose.
Okay.
On purpose.
Tyus fucked him up. That's why Tyus got the jet. Tyus busted that.
Tyus is a boy. He probably was playing with him, with Tyus.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Tyus on a team. Yeah, I give you the jet because you was fucking the niggas up with me.
But
he's facilitating. Shout out to Tyus.
Look at they work ethic, bro. Look at, bro. Be serious. He came here thinking, all right, I can get these young bulls.
Watch the tape.
I can get these young bulls to really work.
Mm-hmm.
I can get these young bulls to go ham and, you know, we can be a playoff team.
Mm-hmm.
And last year, they became a playoff team. What position, though?
He realized these niggas was hard.
No, what position did they come in the playoffs?
Eight.
That was last seed. But that's because Jimmy got hurt and missed the last
and if he did
six
not,
games, right?
If he did not
and before he went
return,
down, it was the fourth seed.
And if he did not return, they was not making the playoffs.
That's probably true.
It's more so about the performance in the playoffs. Look at where did Wiggins go and where did Cat go?
You can't chalk that up to it's the first year in the playoffs. You can't
it's
give him that.
First year.
You can't give. You can't, I'm not talking about Wiggins. You can't give Cat that first year in the playoffs. You're playing number one seed.
You can't give him that. It's Wiggins' first year in the playoffs too. This
That's
is
what I'm saying.
First.
But I don't really.
No,
I'm,
bro.
I'm talking about Cat specifically.
Cat ain't big enough.
He had a game where he scored 1 point, right?
Yeah, for
but
sure.
Then he had a 1 point game.
I'm not saying it's excusable.
No, bro.
I'm not saying he didn't
bro,
fuck
listen,
up.
No, bro, listen. You live here.
Right.
You see how much they boast his ass. He's downtown everywhere, right?
Yeah.
He don't put up KG numbers to get treated like KG. Tell the truth.
He's not KG.
He does.
So don't
KG
treat
numbers.
Him like that.
He's not
KG. Don't treat him like that.
No.
Don't treat him like that. This stuff
he
that
not a, he not a dog.
Minnesota
like
are giving stuff when they're not
so
being
y'all,
earned.
But you gotta give him. That. You gotta
no,
give him
you
that
can't give
you
him nothing.
Give
he has to earn it.
You gotta sell tickets, right?
Bro, he has to earn it. He ain't
it
selling
somebody.
Tickets.
You
is
gotta
it?
Market somebody.
Is it? No, he ain't earning nothing. That's why you bring
Wiggins
a star
selling
in.
A couple
in.
Tickets.
We a Wiggin. No,
I mean
no.
Cat,
Butler.
Cat selling a couple
Butler's
tickets.
The ticket seller. He was supposed to be the ticket seller. That's why he came. But listen, all the other people around him didn't make him want to stay because these niggas didn't want to work. That showed.
It just comes down to the
y'all really. Remember,
man.
He kept saying, "I want to stay here." You know, I want to, but they didn't want to work, bro. Town still ain't going crazy.
So let me ask.
Wiggins still ain't going.
Let me ask this question:
Do you think Ben Simmons? Let me ask this question. Do you think Ben Simmons and Joel Embiid are workers?
Embiid, yes. The Embiid just dropped 39 and 17.
But is he a worker?
Yeah. Yes. He he's getting proved. Bro, if you didn't see, he's a Jayhawk. He's from me. Hold on, time out. Hold on. Time out. Bro, he's a Jayhawk. That's my school, bro.
Fuck that.
No, he was trash.
Fuck them niggas.
Bro, no, bro, he was trash at Kansas. Bro, he was trash at Kansas.
His ass dunked on his
yes. He, bro, he was trash in Kansas, bro. He never dropped all them points, them jump shots, them threes he's shooting for y'all. He never did that with us.
Who, Joel?
Yeah.
No.
Now he's doing that shit. That's work ethic, bro.
Facts.
That's
so
work
ethic. So he's working.
Yes, bro, because so how? How is he now? Is he doing? He's doing all this shit now. He wasn't doing that shit with Kansas. We would have won a championship.
I'm playing,
but he didn't.
I'm playing devil's advocate because Joel is definitely one of my favorite players in the league. So don't get me wrong. But does eating a Big Mac on the sideline before the game, does that count as work? Oh, and you think Jimmy Butler's going to look at that
African.
Shit? And
this nigga is serious. African. Where the fuck you from? Nigga, African. Dude, he from the root. Nigga, ain't give up. The fuck? He's from the root.
You don't care.
Bro, this nigga can do all things.
I hear what you're saying. They can do anything. What? Yeah, fast.
Nigga,
can do
you say both. Probably eat a Big Mac.
Do something to eat. Let me ask another question. After last season, Sixers got eliminated in game 5 by the Celtics, right? If you were Brett Brown and you were in the exit meeting with Joel Embiid, Joel, this is what I need you to work on this summer and be prepared to do next year. What are those three things that he was supposed to work on?
The things he's doing now.
Before you didn't have, no. What are those three things?
I need you to put up more numbers.
More numbers.
And rebounds and rebounds and points.
So
more
you
numbers.
Score more.
And rebound more.
And rebound more.
And protect that paint.
And protect the paint.
And he's doing...
And he's improved in all three of those things?
Not
stuff?
Protecting the paint.
So two of those three things he
going
got
crazy.
Better in.
Going crazy.
Now one thing he didn't work. So crazy. One thing he didn't work on.
Yeah.
Right?
One thing, hey.
All right. Now I'm Ben Simmons. You're in the exit meeting with Brett Brown. Wait. You're in the exit...
Shoot.
You're in the
shoot.
Exit meeting with
I
Brett
know what
Brown.
What you're going to say. Shoot the ball, so
did he get better at that?
Absolutely not. He won't shoot it.
Okay,
that's why I said I still ain't seen the nigga shoot.
So
yet.
Where the fuck did he work at? When was he working?
Okay, but maybe these puppies are different puppies than those puppies, and I'm gonna train them to be dogs.
How the fuck he know?
Shit,
I'd rather be in Philly with this number. This team,
I could make a playoffs with Philly.
Conference
I would too. All right,
this team got knocked off in the first round with this all star with this top notch, this top notch player who only scored 1 point against an undersized.
Is Wiggins an all star in the East?
He's garbo.
He's the USA versus
if he goes to the
international all star.
He's lost.
He's always
his career's over. He goes to the East. Some real defenders in the East.
He gonna go to Toronto and clown.
He gonna go to Toronto and clown.
He's not. He's a Brandon Ingram.
Is Cat an All Star in the East?
He was an All Star in the West.
Maybe. Yeah. If you're an All Star in the East, you should transfer to the East.
I think.
If you want to the West, you should transfer.
I think I would take Ben Simmons and Joel over Wiggins and Cat only because of Wiggins. Only because of Wiggins and Simmons comparison.
You like that?
Way
so
better.
Who you think gonna bang? Who
Joel
who gonna put
Kat,
up better numbers?
Joel and Kat are,
no,
I mean,
who gonna put up better numbers?
Right there. I like Joel
who gonna
better.
Put up better numbers.
And I feel what you said.
Every time
because,
they go head to head, no, because Joel love that type of shit. So when it's game time, who put up the numbers? Who win the games? Put it up.
The mat. Far as numbers comparison, they're the same.
No.
One-on-one in that matchup, in midst of the game, I'm
who's
giving it
better,
to Joel Embiid.
Who's a better player?
Joel Embiid.
In the midst of the game, Joel Embiid.
Why?
Matchup-wise, that's what I'm saying. Versus each other, matchup-wise in the game, Joel Embiid.
So if you're going to start your own team.
Everybody else, Cat's good. Cat is good. He just don't show up
in
the playoffs.
No!
I'm
going
to say
last
Joel Embiid.
I'm going Joel Embiid. You got to give him that young for his first time in the playoffs. You got to give him that youth.
That was Joel Embiid's first time in the playoffs last year, too.
He's not a rookie.
And they lost in five games.
Against who?
Against the Celtics.
With all kids.
Timberwolves lost against the Rockets, nigga.
Was that the first round?
Can I give you the factor in that? Is that
was that the first round?
Philly, who lost in the first round?
They lost. Y'all played them in the first round?
No, second round. Eastern Conference Finals.
Oh, thank you, buddy. So don't down them.
Who was the competition?
No,
the first two.
Not the Eastern Conference Finals.
It was the second round.
It was the second round.
Because they played
the first round.
They played the Cavs in the Eastern Conference Finals.
But no, the factor is that
what?
Philadelphia has all youth, man. Like, they're all stars. They all stars.
The Cavs did beat the Cavs did beat the Celtics.
Yeah, he had to think about it. He was like, he relived it in his mind a little bit.
nigga, eyebrow twitch. Like, you son of a bitch.
You didn't want to. They're gonna do it this year. Look, man, there ain't no fucking Cleveland this year.
Look, man. No, they're not.
They're not going to Cleveland.
Cleveland ain't even gonna be there. Look. Anyways, man. Joel Embiid and them boys was really young, fam. And but the crazy part was Boston was young in that matchup too.
Bro, and adding Butler, and you see what Butler been Butler on. To that.
I'm not saying they're not going to be good. No, I'm just saying I don't want Butler to prosper.
Minnesota situation. But Wiggins is like is what he is.
Is
like
it better than the Minnesota situation?
He's a potential player. He's not good to me, bro. He's not.
So that means that Embiid and Ben Simmons are better than Karl Anthony Towns,
Joel
and Wiggins. No. Yes.
I know why you're saying Wiggins is better than...
Ben Simmons is better than Andrew Wiggins.
Why?
For sure.
Why?
Huh?
Why?
Ben Simmons is better than Andrew Wiggins.
When he won't shoot the ball.
Why?
For playing 2-on-2. I'm just gonna back up and
Wiggins gonna shoot that motherfucker.
I'm just gonna back up, play off of him, and help a little bit on Joel Embiid.
But what's the name? Don't shoot.
You don't think Ben Simmons is a?
He don't shoot.
He's not going to shoot it. It don't matter if he's gonna. He's not gonna shoot it.
He's a point guard.
He ain't no damn point guard. He's 6'8".
He's a point guard.
Big as fuck. He's bronze size.
So you don't. So you're not agreeing with us that he's not gonna shoot the ball. And if he does shoot the ball, it's like he's gonna miss.
Yeah. No, I agree.
So how is that even a threat? Like.
Because now that they have threats, we're kind of switching sides now. But now that they have Jimmy Butler, he really doesn't even need to shoot like that right now.
It's going to be moments where you're going
to
need that.
Yeah,
right?
You're going to need to knock down a shot for sure. I agree. Yeah,
he's going to be handling the ball, going to the rack, dishing it out.
Yeah.
So what about in the late Magic in the game? Late really in the game, like I can hack a Shaq Ben Simmons.
Oh, but Magic
when I can shot. Hack a Ben.
Huh? When he did shoot.
Yeah.
What about when he had
that baby hook, you know what I'm saying? He got to his spot.
Right.
You can't
hack a Magic.
That whack-ass free throw.
You can't hack a Magic. Huh? But you can hack a Ben.
Right now you can, yeah.
You can't hack Wiggins. He's knocking down at the line. At the free throw line?
He'll knock him down.
Maybe.
He better be able to do his only
fucking points.
No, he can get decent amount of buckets. He's a Brandon Ingram to me, bro. His ceiling is a lot of potential, but he just don't never reach that potential.
Yeah, I get it. That's true.
Andrew Wiggins and Joel Embiid came out the same year, same team.
Mm-hmm.
Who's doing better?
Joel, for sure.
All right, then. That's why the team's better.
I don't like Wiggins. I don't think he's
Minnesota
the one.
Minnesota just spent how much on him last year?
So, Wiggins? Yeah. I wouldn't have gave him that contract. He knew he shouldn't have gave him that contract.
Rakeem, you're saying that, Joel Embiid over Cat or Cat over Joel?
I like Joel better.
Why he do got you the think Cat is better though?
But I, huh? Why do I don't. You think I don't. I didn't say Cat was better. I'm saying I like Joel better. So I'm gonna. I think Joel might edge him out a little bit.
Yeah. Ain't no, to me,
his
ain't
post,
no
his moves in the post. I mean, because he is a center. At the end of the day, he's a fucking center.
Cat do his numbers.
At the end of the day, he's a fucking center. Cat spends too much time at the three to me.
Yeah, he does too much time out there. But he will do it.
He's not strong enough to me. I think of that picture with DeMarcus Cousins like this, nigga, and Cat look like he's struggling in the face, like he pushing out a big shit, trying to get around this nigga.
You know me.
DeMarcus Cousins just looking like, nigga, what the fuck are you doing? So that's what I think of Cat. I think he's a little soft. Not that he's like a soft guy, but I think he's just not strong enough. He don't got his NBA muscles right now. Like, he don't got his grown man shit. He's still a kid just getting it. You know what I'm saying? I think Joel's there already.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Right. So, I like Joel a little bit. I think Joel might be a little bit better.
So,
okay. So
but I think they have a similar ceiling.
So, look, I ain't gonna dog him that bad. He ain't that soft.
Who?
Cat? Cat.
Yeah, no, I'm not saying that.
Because he did a 39-19 against Sacramento. He did a 25-21 against Brooklyn. He did a 35-16 against New Orleans. He did a 34-9 against Portland. He did a 38-20 against Memphis. He did a 28-7 against Denver. He did 28-9 against Brooklyn, 35-23 against Chicago. He did a 38-10 against
Cleveland. Just to set this context, this is all after Jimmy left, right?
This is in October.
Jimmy left?
Jimmy just left.
He left.
This is in November. This is November. This is from the 9th.
So these are his numbers.
There in October.
These are his numbers after Jimmy
was
Jimmy
in left. October.
He was there in October.
He was there in November too. No, these are November numbers.
All these numbers are post Jimmy Butler trade.
No.
Most of them are.
Yeah, some of them are.
Good. What you about to say, Sean?
Nothing. Let's move on to something else.
I'm saying I know Jimmy's a good player. He's a great player. He's an all-star player.
You hating on Jimmy, man? You said you don't want no success.
I just have hometown love for the Wolves, and I can't root for you. And before Jimmy got there, I liked the Sixers a lot because I like Joel. I think Joel's one of my favorite players. Like I said,
Joel Embiid had a 39-16 against Memphis. He had a 36-18 against Miami.
He's a
problem. Had a 36-13-10 against Orlando, 26-7 against Utah, 40-11 against Charlotte, 36-17 against Phoenix, 32-19 against New Orleans, 33-12 against Cleveland, 36-12 against Brooklyn, 30-14 against New York.
All right, man. I think we've exhausted this Jimmy Butler, Cat Williams.
Yeah, we want to edit that.
It's all over. That's what it's over right now.
I said the stats wrong.
Shout out to Cat Williams.
Cat was trash, bro.
What else is going on in the world, bro? What else, man? How y'all doing? We didn't do our personal check-ins, man. What's going on with y'all this week? What's good, June? What's up, man?
Shit, man. I gotta go soon.
I gotta go soon.
It is date night, man.
Is it?
So I don't have to go soon, but I will be leaving shortly.
It is Friday. That's what y'all plans is? Y'all booed up this weekend? This Friday? This evening?
I wouldn't say booed up. I'm gonna go out. Friday, yeah, I am. But Saturday, I'm gonna try to get out, man. I'm gonna try to get uptown or something, man. Maybe go room that new spot that opened up, man. I think, we need to go down there, man, and see what that's about.
You said where?
Gold Room. Yeah, man. I'm talking about, I was trying to hit that with the fellas, with the guys. Take your girl, enjoy yourself. Me and my lady gonna step out on Friday night, tonight, man. But Saturday I'm out with the fellas, man. All right, with the dog. Now, if you in the doghouse, be in the doghouse respectfully, man. Don't be throwing dirt on the brothers who ain't, man. All right.
Mm-hmm. All right, what about you, Jim? You going out tonight? You caked up? It's a day night? That's why you gotta go?
Yeah, man. This is gonna be
sushi tango, man.
Sushi tango?
Sushi tango, man.
For real?
Nah, nigga, I'm just going off anything he say.
Oh, okay. Watch the table.
That was Sean Big Head today. What you got going on tonight, man?
I think I'm gonna go. A few of my coworkers and colleagues is going to this little bar or whatever, celebrate my supervisor. She's got a new job. So
she's not your supervisor no more?
Nah.
So you really shouldn't give a fuck.
But you're going to give a fuck. It's kind of like the culture of the why. Like when somebody leaves out, you do a happy hour.
Oh.
And
so what happens when somebody dies? Do they give you like $1,000 money?
This girl died this year.
So what did y'all do? Did y'all give her some money?
Well, she was kind of in a different program area, so I don't know what they did, but I didn't do nothing.
So I'm thinking, fuck the why. Fuck you and your new job. Work is over.
I mean, yeah, maybe, but I'm just gonna go support, man. My people are gonna be there, so
I step out for a little minute. When you pass, I'm gonna be looking for them to help me and your family.
When I die?
Yeah.
I'm not dying no time soon.
I know, but I'm gonna be looking for their ass because you dedicated some time to this.
No, she didn't. She got a new job.
I know. You dedicated your time right now. I know, but you dedicating your time to them right now. You know, to go kick it, cause she getting a new job. Your old boss now is getting a whole new job.
Yep.
Gonna celebrate. Yeah. You'll tell her shit you wanted to say? That you used to want to say? Like, man, you was a bitch.
I didn't fuck with you them first 6 months, bitch. Nah, I ain't gonna say that. She my peoples, man. She cool people.
Oh, okay, that's what's up.
Yeah. So, you know, just gonna go have a little fun. Come back home. Kick with my lady.
Oh, she can't go with you?
Nah, she ain't going with me.
Oh, why not?
She got plans already.
Y'all living it then. It's mm-hmm. the best way to do it.
Shout out Black Love, man.
Salute to Black Love.
Yeah, that's what we was trying to say. That's what we really was trying to say, man. I'm so tongue tied. I'm emotional, man. That's what we really was trying to get into. Was just that Black Love is excellent. Excellent.
Tongue tied.
Yeah. Chill on that shit, man. Chill on that shit, man. I was thinking about my lady. I drew it a little bit. Oh, I'm sorry, God. Man.
I'm tongue tied.
Right. Hey, y'all cold with that one, man, because I was really trying to get a kind of, you know, trying to get something going there. But yeah, since we're in a relationship, let's say, like, can we talk about some relationship topics, man?
Yeah, you want one? I got one off the top.
You got one off the top?
No, go ahead.
Oh. If y'all would have seen the way he just pulled his phone out. No, I got one.
No, I wasn't, no.
Hey, you got some shit you want to get off his chest? Look, she was tripping, man.
I was thinking on Wednesday.
No, you know, I was, you know, I'm going straight to,
oh my God.
I was going straight to, Instagram, because, you know, Gilly the Kid always got the, you know, the coldest, you know.
Should I go to, you about to play audio or something? Wait, pause. I play the audio. It's Gilly the Kid. Keep talking while I find the video.
Yeah, you know, Gilly always, you know, he always got a video that's like, you know, a relationship type of thing. Like, he was like, hey, you know, yo, Gilly. You know, I've been dating this girl for about 3 years.
This one?
Yeah.
Top right?
Yeah. All
right. You know, she in the bed with him?
No, that's his girl. But it'd be people sending him stories about their relationship, asking him to give him gift. Because he got, you see in the quote, it says $1 million worth of game, you know, for free. You know, so he be giving people advice off relationship stuff. So just go ahead and, play it.
Let's get into this thing.
Hey, man.
The game real quick, right? One of the main questions I be getting asked in my DM is about social media. OG, I need some game. My boyfriend always be liking these thot ass Instagram model pics. Like, OG, you know, my girl always be liking niggas pics, OG. I mean, so what? Nigga, that's what Instagram is for. To like pics. I would always be in a bad mood if I got mad every time Tootie like niggas pick. She stay on Idris Alba page.
She like shit right now.
Matthew McConaughey and Adam Levine and
Adam Levine.
Memphis Bleek.
I do not.
Salute to Bleek.
But we got a rule. As long as you don't leave no hard eyes, you know hard eyes turn into what too? Black eyes, that's
right.
Y'all mean I was with the game real quick, right?
So, yeah, man, he got, you know.
Hey, just don't eat no hard eyes. That's a real shit.
You know, he got all types of shit. You know what I'm saying? He be snapping.
You can double tap, but don't leave no fucking hard eyes. I'm blacking your shit.
You know, so hold on. So, click on that. It's a specific one.
Oh, that wasn't the one?
Yeah. It's a specific one, you know.
Tell me, man. You can say third, fourth row.
It's just, I wanted to put a topic out there for y'all to talk about.
So what, you want to get our perspective on liking Instagram pics? I don't do it.
Oh, you don't like
like shit. I like the homie shits or the homegirls. If I fuck around, I don't like nothing that can be misconstrued. I've been there before. I've got the screenshots. So I don't even do it no more.
It's just Instagram.
I know, but I just don't do it because...
These are pictures. Now, if it's a personal, like a girl you don't like or, you know...
What you mean you don't like?
Hey, man. Hey. It's just Instagram, bro.
All right, so here we go. I'm going to tell y'all a personal story. This is real life shit, all right? Real life shit. I was in my bag... You know what I'm saying? She know this. We talk about this. I was in my bag. I was doing my little investigative. You know what I'm saying? I was in my private eye bag. Yeah, I was in my private eye bag. So I'm scrolling. So I'm scrolling down. You know, you can see, you know what I'm saying? The not the explore page, but the page you see who's liking what and who's leaving comments or what. So I'm scrolling. Looking for my girl. Okay, this is what she doing. She liking all these pics. Cool. I'm trying to think about I noticed she's like, yeah, I noticed she's like one pick. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, okay, let me go to the next shit.
No, you was investigating.
Yeah, I was in my bags. She liked the next pick. So I go to the nigga page. The fuck is this nigga? Now, I'm looking at all this nigga pictures and seeing how many of her, his pictures she liked. She liked mad pictures, nigga. Like, mad pictures, bro. And I'm going to her page, like, okay, how many of her pics is this nigga liking? He liking mad pics.
It's probably at least 5 or 6 other followers that's like that, though, bro.
Right. But this is just my, this is my story.
Okay.
So I immediately hop in my feelings. Who the what the fuck is going on here? But I didn't say nothing initially. I said, let me just keep watching. You know what I'm saying? Let me just keep a tab. So I kept tabs. You know what I'm saying? She posted a new pic. Well, okay, let me see who liked this motherfucker. Oh, he right there. All right, bet. Every once in a while, go back to this nigga page. All right, let me see what the fuck he got going on. He got a new pic. She liked it. So eventually, I'm like, all right, I don't know what the fuck going on, but I will find out. You know what I'm saying? So I asked her. I said, look, yo, I noticed you liking some pics. He liking a lot of your pics. You liking all of his shits. Just tell me what the fuck going on right now. And she said, that's the homie. He used to talk to my whatever. I think maybe my, it was a minute ago. So this is just the homie. He used to talk to whoever. That's my friend. It's not even like that. I don't like this nigga at all. I said, but he's liking all of your shit. So as a man, from a man's perspective, he is trying to pull up. Like, he's trying to slide in. Like, he's priming. He's letting it marinate. And he's just waiting on his moment. She like, all right, whatever. What you want me to do? Unfollow him? You want me to unlike the pics? Nah, well, you can keep it there. Fuck, keep following him. I don't give a fuck. I just want to know on the front end, like, yo, what's up? I noticed this. I can't let it eat at my brain, so I'm just going to ask you. So we had a conversation. I was cool after the conversation, whatever. Fast forward some time. I don't know if it was a couple weeks or maybe a month. But she told me, hey, bae, you remember that one nigga that was liking my pics and you asked me about? Yeah, I remember him. What's up? Why he trying to slide in my DMs and shoot a shot? Oh, for real? Yeah, he did. So what you say? Oh, I said, it's not like that. I immediately blocked him and now he's on the block list forever. So that's my story. Moral of my story is, don't let the shit eat at your brain, fellas. If you notice some shit and you peeping some shit out, had a conversation. It don't mean you gotta go snap and you don't gotta, bitch, what the fuck going on and this and that. But just had a conversation. Like, yo, what's up? I noticed this. Let me know. Am I bugging? Or does this have some validity to it? And you just, if you trust your girl, you just gotta fuck with whatever she says. That's what it is.
Okay, I just sent you something else.
All right.
Niggas just got a lot of pride, man. That conversation, sure. That conversation is a tough conversation to have, man.
Don't play that out loud, man.
Don't play it?
I said, go and play that out loud. Go and play that.
Go and play that.
Yeah, for sure. But I mean, so I don't like motherfuckers' pictures and shit. If it's not like some, just on some, like if y'all post some shit, I'll double tap or whatever. But if it's like, if I'm on my explore page and see a bad bitch with ass all out and shit, I'm not double tapping that shit. I might like it in my head. Yeah, I like that one. But I'm not gonna double tap. Cause I don't want them problems. What? What you say?
That's interesting.
Okay.
But yeah, go and play that video, bro.
Alright.
Miles worth of game real quick, right? I know we living in the era of the twerking, and we living in the era where women post up 40,000 pics on Instagram and 39,741 of them be ass shots. And I'm not gonna lie, I scroll down the gram, I see them bubbles, I press like, but you bitches couldn't be my woman. My woman will never be out here leading with her ass. She gotta lead with her class. She gotta understand that them titties and patties is for daddy. You hear me? You bitches be out here talking about, girl, look how many likes I got. Bitch, you're naked. Fuck is you talking about, you're supposed to get likes. And a lot of you bitches be more naked on Instagram than you be in your own bedroom. You bitches so concerned about getting likes that the nigga you living with don't even like your ass no more. whole time you think you out here promoting yourself, and bitch, you're really demoting yourself. Right? And let me give y'all $1 million.
Yeah, that was a.
He kind of sounds like he's mad a little bit. To me.
That was a. That was a. Some. One of the homies sent that.
That was a little bit of game,
fam. Y'all like that shit?
I didn't. You know.
Y'all think them bitches that's on Instagram half naked, posting pics. Y'all don't think them niggas. Y'all don't think they getting wifed up?
The women.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So what the fuck is he talking about?
That's not my type. I agree, cause
it's a lot of niggas types.
I think double tapping though.
I'm gonna give
you the double tap though, but you can't get no ring or nothing like support. That. Nah.
Yeah. What'd you say, LA?
I think the process you mean.
The what?
The process.
What process?
The process of getting married.
You from Philly?
When you are, you know, when you are in the Instagram like life, when you're that public figure. Mm-hmm. I think the process of you getting married will be harder than you not doing that.
Really?
Yeah.
No, because a lot of these chicks can get
trust issues. A lot of times, if she's that bad, you nigga gotta be having a lot of money. How many broke girls you know? I mean, I don't like anything. But I'm just saying, it's like most of the time, then it's always, you know.
Well, I see the point you're trying to make. That you could be an Instagram model and still have all these things and still be lifeable, right?
You can, right.
But you still could. Yeah, but it all goes back to preference. Mm-hmm. Me personally, I mean, I don't think I would want my wife putting it all out there.
To
like
be
that.
Instagram, she was getting a bag though.
If she was getting a bag for being an Instagram model,
yeah,
and that's your profession,
and she's showing ass.
A lot of them get paid for that shit.
But I'm just showing like free.
Is this like the long term career plan? Or are we gonna invest and do something different? Or what are we doing? This is just you. I mean, you going 50. This is what we doing.
I mean, I don't think that's gonna last that long unless you just keep that shit tight. But
eventually, you gotta have a different plan. So right. I'm hoping that plan's gonna do an effect before we have a family, and then my kids gotta see that, or the people, anybody just go online and see my son, mom like that. Like,
right?
That's a little different.
But so are you saying initially you wouldn't wife no? I'm trying to think of an Instagram
model.
Who's a popular Instagram model?
Listen, I would date an Instagram model.
Okay.
If it went down that route where we eventually got married. Yeah, but I mean, I would hope that she would want to do something different than an Instagram model.
So before you put the ring on it, she got to stop? That's what you're saying? You going to have that conversation like, yo, all right, what's next?
She got to show me something.
She got to elevate.
She got to show
she
me something.
She can't be doing the same thing. You can't be just showing your ass.
It just can't be you. Like,
you got to move on from showing
your
ass.
I got to see that you want to do something different.
What if she was doing it for like a publication?
What is a public? No.
Like a Playboy type thing or a King magazine or something like that. No.
That's not my type.
Look. What I'm saying is that you can't have pictures taken of you forever, because eventually you're not going to be as beautiful as what the people want to see. You know what I'm saying?
It's always going to be somebody younger, a little bit bad, a little bit yeah. I get
exactly.
It.
Mm-hmm. So I'm saying like you have to have a different plan. If you don't, then eventually I'm going
to just
be
like how they like, looking for you know you like what are yeah. You? So you have to, you know.
Mm-hmm. I imagine that I can't be an Instagram model and just that's gonna be my shit forever. Like,
right.
I just take selfies for nigga the rest of my motherfucking life. Nigga, yeah, I'm 70.
I'm gonna get married. I'm gonna have my wife man, and she gonna have the kids. I'm like, hold on, babe, hold on.
Yeah. I go on the model for like Tommy Hilfiger and shit. I think I do watches. I'm a hand model.
Hand model. Tell us, baby, a hand model till you about 60.
Yeah, I mean, I guess, but
that motherfucker.
I'm a
gene model.
I'm
the only my waist. You can only see my waist. I'm
getting that Brett Favre bag, huh?
Best poses in the pants.
Getting the Wranglers bag.
You feel me? You see now, if we elevate and doing something like that, and we putting our money somewhere else, then yeah. But if all you want to do is just take pictures and get you know 3 or 5, and you know that.
So you gotta have you gotta have other interests. That's what you're saying.
Yeah, it gotta be more to you than you. You can't just be Instagram model. Like,
do you think that's all? That they are,
my bad.
Majority of them, or do you think that they all have?
Different. Some people got different motives. There's some women who just. You know,
Cardi
like
started
that.
In the strip club, and now she's one of the top performer
artists
out right now.
She changed the game. She changed the game for
them. Elevated. Now she can put her clothes on and rap if she want to.
Right. She don't got to get naked no more.
Exactly.
So is it a part of the game? And do you knock women? Do you knock them for playing the game?
No. No, I don't knock nobody hustle. I don't like nobody hustle. You gotta get it how you live, man. But I mean, just know that you gotta live it.
That's facts.
I'm just from the school of thought that I don't really like how a lot of men find it upon themselves to tell women how to be women. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't think that's cool.
Yeah, I feel you. Like, it's the same thing about women telling men how to be men. Remember how that little whole scenario of, you know, women trying to tell men how to be, how men is supposed to be?
Yeah.
It's the same thing.
Yeah.
I think it's just... To me, I think it's just like he said. It's what you like.
Find who you happy with, man.
Yeah, that's
what it's about. Settle down with who you happy with, man.
That's all it's about.
Y'all get y'all business plan, everybody get y'all some money and some security, man.
I think
and,
everybody
and live your best
with
life
with this social media age. Everybody
don't like big booty strippers. Like, you know, she getting a living on big booty strippers. I might like that. You know, to be my girlfriend. You know, you know, I'm trying to. We just can't stay at Aldi's all this time. We gotta elevate. We gotta go from Aldi's to Pyramid to Chicago to Vegas.
A lot of them go to
Vegas to Miami. That's where we go.
I don't want the bitches to go to Iowa. I'm good.
You go to Iowa, we go in separate ways.
Yeah,
fuck we can't do the midway.
If your girl shipping Iowa, she's coming
she's
back
really
with chlamydia,
trying,
nigga.
She's really not trying to be a stripper. She's really not trying to be a stripper. She's trying.
She's coming back with the clap. Yeah, that's what she's doing.
She gonna let one of them country ass white niggas hit that shit.
Yeah,
see, it's a wrap.
Yeah, them is the ones you better not put no damn
fucking
ring on.
Farm bred high school football playing ass country ass white
them,
niggas.
And the bitches that can't get be an Instagram model. You know, look that damn good.
They get 10 in Iowa though.
Come on, stop bashing them, man. Let's move on to something else because I'm ready to go in on them hoes.
Hey man, dude. I sent another one for you, man.
I thought that was the same one.
Come on,
man.
What's up? LA sent the topics to us.
Hey,
it's
the same homie.
Alley-ooping these to us.
The same homie. The same homie.
Gilly the kid,
these,
nigga. You wanna watch
the same homie? The same homie.
Oh man, we not promoting Gilly on this motherfucker. Unless he give us a bag, bro. Move on. I'm not doing another Gilly topic, bro. I'll talk all through it.
Shout out to the last one.
I will do the grinding beat on this fucking table. It's nigga, we're one. Not doing no more Gilly topics
one,
unless he's paying
it's
us.
The last one.
No. Bro, move the last on. One.
You follow him?
If it's another relationship topic, bro, no.
I don't follow him, but go ahead. Because I'm easier to really...
follow this nigga, man.
Come on, man. Last one.
You search this shit up.
Because these
no,
are perfect,
this is not the
man.
What we looking for.
Now, let me just play this last one. Man.
Last
let
one.
Let me get this last one, bro. Bro. Let him get this. Let, ahead, let him man. Get this one off.
I'm picking the outro song.
Go ahead. You should go ahead.
We got one more topic after this. This. We still good, bro. We 157 in.
Dude just said he gotta go soon, man.
No, we good, man. Look, we
all right. Let's get it.
We're
bro.
Making
on,
movies every. We making movies every week.
Go to the Gilly Kid.
We going at least 2 hours and 15 minutes every week.
Go to the Gilly Kid,
fellas. That's in my DM, right? And they be asking me questions, and you know they be saying they caught they woman cheating, and you know things that actually she cheated on me, and should I take her back, and you know what you think, old head. And I just want you to all the guys out there that catch they woman cheating, right? I just want you to know this. When your woman cheat on you with another nigga, just know she sucked his dick better than she suck your dick. You know why? Because she suck your dick all the time. So she give you them lazy dick sucks. But she couldn't get that brand new nigga no lazy dick suck. So she just gave that man the best dick suck that he had in a minute. You hear me? Sucked his balls out of his dick and spit them down at the end of the bit. Go get your balls, nigga. Just know that. Right? You know what I'm talking?
First of all, I just want to know who's DMing Gilly the Kid for relationship advice.
Man. What would Gilly do?
Hey, bro, real talk. Who's going to Gilly for relationship advice?
Kill yourself,
you niggas,
bro.
That's your
you
first problem.
You're a grown-ass man. You gotta be a grown man to have a fucking Instagram.
Say it out loud, nigga.
You Gilly the Kid.
What?
You DMing Gilly, fam. DMing Gilly, grown man. What would Gilly do?
If your girl cheat on you and the first thing you thinking
what
of
fuck,
is
man?
What the fuck would Gilly do?
Yeah, my nigga Gilly.
You got some other problems that we need to address
my nigga Gilly.
First, nigga.
So how you feel about his explanations? What he said
about his your girl
whole
sucking
thing,
another nigga's dick better than yours? Maybe I don't.
Maybe
probably I don't know.
Hey man, let's move on. Shout out to Gilly the Kid, man, for the Carter One work, man. Let's move on, man.
This is the Gilly the Kid podcast.
No, the fuck it.
You want to shout out his Instagram?
Give us a bag, man.
You want to tell the people to go follow him?
Man, hey, man.
$30.
All you got to do is look up the hashtag, man. What does it say? Million dollar worth the game for free.
Yeah, but he fucked up because he spelled dollars with a Z, and that's not good for hashtags if you in the market and shit.
You feel me, man?
And he put four as the number four, not the word four. Yeah. But whatever. Shout out to Gibby.
Some funny shit,
$150,
man.
We promote you on here.
So that wasn't no, that wasn't no funny shit?
$150.
That shit, it was the balls, the spit balls at the end of the bed. That shit was funny.
Man, that was...
He's trying to get... He's in his plies bag right now. I see what he's doing. I'm not mad at him.
Let's go, man.
Do your thing,
hey,
bro.
Man, did y'all see, the game last night? Matter of fact, no, man. It's, my mom, bro.
Nah, nigga, yeah. Hey, so yeah, Christmas is coming up. That's the next holiday. Y'all ready for that?
I don't celebrate that shit.
Me neither, brother. Black Power.
Yeah, you know. They came at me with some Secret Santa shit yesterday at my job. And I'm
what you say?
They had the white Santa on the top of the paper. I said, I'm not doing this shit.
I signed up.
You signed up for Secret Santa?
Yeah.
At your job?
Yeah.
You don't even know them niggas, bro.
They don't even know him.
They gonna give me what I put on that paper.
What you put? What you put?
No, they not.
Nigga, y'all ain't my secret son. Y'all don't even know what the fuck on my paper.
I ain't gonna tell nobody.
What you want? What you want? What you want for Christmas? Favorite snacks. I said, I need the Gushers. I need some fruit roll ups, and I need some chocolate covered peanuts.
Man. Y'all like that bullshit?
Gushers sound like a light skinned nigga to me.
Yeah, that's definitely light skinned.
Sound light skinned to me.
All right, let me continue. Go ahead, man. What you want to know, man? Yeah, I did Secret Santa, man.
No, I'm not
my
doing
favorite
that.
Teams on there and all that shit.
I'm not doing that bullshit.
I said, hey, man.
Hey, Secret Santa.
Let's do it, man. Let's
Secret Santa's kind of, you know.
Y'all don't do that
family
shit.
Family thing.
I was mad as fuck when my girl
work,
put
they gonna ask me and I'm like, no. Quantity.
But happy no, Quantity. I don't celebrate Christmas like the whole ideology or the religious thing of Christmas. Like
nobody even knows.
But that's a time like you get with your family and you know y'all do whatever y'all do and exchange gifts if you exchange gifts if you're that fortunate or if you're fortunate enough to spend time with family, that's what you do about the holiday time.
Christmas is another fucking day to me. I don't got kids, so it might be a little different.
Yeah, it should be, though, if you think about it.
So when, when you do have kids, what are you going to do?
We're not celebrating Christmas.
You're not doing the whole gifts, wake up, it's the 25th.
No, I don't really, I'm not into that shit.
Hey, to be honest,
Maybe it might change, you know what I'm saying? I don't know.
Everybody different.
I was mad when my girl put them goddamn Christmas lights on the balcony. But fuck it. Hey, they look all right. So.
Hey, this year my mom wanted to change it.
Cheer.
My mom wanted to, she didn't want to do Christmas like that no more.
Mm-hmm.
She wanted to. She said, "If everybody wanted, you know, do Christmas like that, they might as well pitch in their own money to pay for a ticket so we can go somewhere."
That's cool. I rock with that
trip.
It's just
every Christmas. Instead of
it's all about capitalism, bro. Yeah, all these holidays, man. They get niggas to spend
it's
so
not
much
like we
fucking
go
money
somewhere on Christmas
for no fucking reason. You spending all your money on gifts.
Bro,
and
if you see the setup, bro.
All
Black
of this shit,
Friday's here.
And then you put yourself in the debt, and you can't get out that debt until next Christmas, nigga. And then you gonna do the same shit over again.
I hope you ain't going in debt for Christmas gifts, man. That's not what
it's better
about,
not.
Man. That ain't really what Christmas is about.
I mean, I think
a lot of parents do. A lot of you'd be surprised how many people.
That's
a lot
that's people, not what Christmas is about, but that's not what it's about.
I think a lot of people do go in debt on Christmas, trying to buy gifts.
Bro, you know the suicide rate is the highest ever all year on Christmas. More people kill themselves around the Christmas holiday than any other
Valentine's
time during the year.
Because
all of this fucking Valentine's Day is up there too. All of this fucking pressure to buy gifts and have all and spend all this money and all of this shit, and it's bullshit, bro. It's for no reason. It's for money.
I like the movies though.
What, Christmas movies?
Yeah. What you Christmas mean, songs by the Jacksons. That's
this Christmas.
Motown.
It was the night before Christmas.
Hey. That's Temptation.
Ooh.
Nigga, you said Motown, didn't you?
Merry Christmas. Silent night. Holy night.
Oh, but you gonna sing that shit.
Nah,
you see how you singing the shit?
Holy, you know black people got a way of bringing the soul out some shit, nigga. Niggas got a way, bro.
Free.
You see how niggas sing the national anthem whenever? You feel that shit when a nigga sing it. When Houston singing a national anthem? Oh my God. I was ready to join the army.
I ain't even heard of the Jacksons.
Huh?
Christmas album.
You haven't?
I'm asking you.
I have.
He come for the jugular.
I know that's your man's, bro.
You ain't heard none of that shit. You ain't heard it even. You would have sung it first.
That's your man's, nigga.
I would have sung that first.
Because what really Christmas is about is what the Jackson sound.
What's that?
It's about giving love on Christmas.
That's what it's about. It's not about Jesus. We're gonna lose the Christian fan base, bro. Be careful.
That is.
So you more afraid to lose the gay fan base than the Christians?
No, I'm sorry. It's all the base about me too. Yeah, you better edit this shit out, bitch.
I'm gonna edit this shit, nigga. We're not saying nothing wrong.
Cover the mic like, hey, nigga. He got to go now, bro.
Get up there and go against the grain.
We're not signed, nigga. Hey, this is the beautiful thing about being independent, my brother. We don't have no creative.
You endorse this, man. You can tell us what the fuck to say, man. But yeah.
Nah, nigga.
If we wrong,
right,
tell us
price
we,
to endorse us.
Hey, look. If we wrong, tell us we wrong. Educate us. Yeah, man. I'm not an expert on the goddamn thing.
You know, ain't nobody God.
I beg to differ. I'm God, nigga.
Oh, you a God?
Yeah. We all are.
Okay.
So it depends on what you think God is.
Well, I was gonna say, cause you know the Catholic, Baptist.
Catholic Baptist name.
I'm saying, you know, both of them. Are they okay with that?
I don't give a fuck what they okay with.
Jews? The Jews are okay with that?
We're not getting into that.
All right, then.
All right. Next topic, man. So, I was scrolling down my timeline, and I seen this interesting, I ain't gonna get into that. Y'all niggas ever been cheating on before?
Yeah, man, nah. So, next thing, you know,
you ever been cheated on before?
Why are we on this relationship shit, man? But, I mean, we can talk about that if you want for something good.
We got to do something for the women viewership. We got to get that up. I was looking at the stats.
I thought we did with the Gilly shit. That was good for the women.
Yeah, it was. All right, we'll leave Gilly alone.
Thank you, Gilly the Kid, for plugging our relationship section of the podcast.
Shout out to Gilly. If you listening, bro, we fuck with you. Carter 2 was amazing.
One.
Carter 1 was crazy, bro. Love your work, man.
Love your work. Hey, somebody roll up, nigga. I'm finna smoke.
Call. Yeah.
Roll up one of them.
I give you a roach.
Roll up one of them.
Your first time back with you. Dang. A roach.
So it's been all right. So let's give a personal update. I ain't answering my own question. Yeah, I'm trying to smoke. Come on.
Because I wasn't gonna do it if you wanted to do it.
I'm a little
on this shoe. How much was this?
On the tipsy side, but fuck it, he grabbed.
How much is this, man?
Hey, you just patted this nigga pockets. It is you. How much is this?
I don't care about him grabbing, man.
Hey, Mr. Officer.
How much?
His license plate number.
Yeah, what is that?
They finna pull you over by the time we leave.
Oh, you know your little kid, your little basketball player came up on me at my job today.
Hey, man, so what's up to you?
He was like, "Hey, what's his name?" He was like, "Levance."
What?
Levance.
No, his name L.A.
They look back like,
what
you?
The fuck?
I swear they look back at me like, what the fuck? They don't know about it. They don't know my name L.A.
He know your street name.
So they was like, they look back like, they're like, that's my coach friend.
Let me check out gray hair. One more time for our smoke, man.
That nigga got gray hair, bro.
A kid?
A kid, 7th grade.
I knew a Mexican dude when I was in middle school that had gray hair.
Fucking hard work.
I'm like, nigga, you work the third shift or something, bro? What the fuck going on with you?
I'm gonna fire that up. Go ahead, throw it in the microwave and put it on 32 seconds.
What's that, macaroni? You still got some chicken in there? I'm about to eat me too. All right, so update.
You finna been in all your shit?
I've been,
This podcast ain't that good.
This whole month, the whole month of November, it's been hashtag no smoke November for me. It's November 30th as of right now when we're recording this podcast.
Should have done this episode around midnight, man. Some people be having schedule conflicts.
Y'all niggas going out.
Right. Stop acting like you ain't got no date.
Yeah, both of y'all niggas. We just talking about this.
He got
who going out?
I ain't got
you ain't going out? I'm going out a little bit. So yeah, I haven't smoked since Halloween, which was 30 days ago. So yeah, I'm gonna smoke, man. We're gonna end this fast right here now. I got a job I had a drug test for. And go ahead, let me know what it is so I can play it on the big speaker. I drug tested for a job. Wait, I gotta get mine off, bro. Yeah,
okay.
I've never been able to pass a drug test in my life since I've been 18.
In my life.
You know what I'm saying?
You sound like you're supposed to cry, my nigga.
My motherfucking life. I never was able to pass a drug test. I never applied for a job that I had a drug test for because I just didn't have confidence in myself that I could finesse the system and get another nigga pee in there somehow. Cause I'm just the type of nigga that I get caught. I get caught, so I just never did. And now,
That's my pitch, man.
As of last Tuesday, I took a drug test, nigga. I took a motherfucking drug test, and I passed that bitch with flying colors, nigga. A+.
Puff, puff, pass.
I felt the spirit of my ancestors when I was in there. They said, nigga, you got it. You got it, cuz. So, yeah, man. So, I passed the drug test. I ain't going to tell y'all what job I'm at, because some of you niggas might be hating and call them niggas. But,
some of the white people. That's what you're trying to say.
Shout out to... got a job as an undertaker, y'all.
Yeah, working at a fucking funeral home.
Cremate bodies. He works security at Cub, y'all.
Cremate bodies. Yeah, they pass a drug test.
The worst job ever. You gotta pass a drug test for that shit. I don't want niggas high doing that job.
You tripped out doing that.
You might see a spirit in that bitch.
I don't want to be high. I don't want to do that job at all.
Yeah, you gotta be sober and shit. Hey, shout out to whoever does that shit.
If I was Undertaker, though, I'd take it hella serious. Like, I'd go all out. I would dress like, nigga, the Undertaker. Nigga, I'd be walking around black ass leather gloves and long robes, wrong leather robes and shit. I'm an Undertaker. Niggas, I know.
How you gonna come in,
Keys,
nigga?
You see me walking to work? That's the Undertaker. He's a bad man, nigga. Yeah, man. I go all out.
You walk in like this.
Yeah, nigga. That's how I be doing. Nigga. That's how I come to work.
Walking in the building and shit.
Yeah, nigga.
You gotta go to the punch-in machine.
Yeah, nigga. We in this bitch, man. Y'all ready to
big ass black coat.
How was you even? See a few spirits, man.
You got the radio. Yeah. Like Radio Raheem with the Bluetooth speaker.
Yup.
Oh, yo, my God.
You man, that bitch playing the Meek album. Now burning up bodies. Nigga working hard. Dedicated as fuck. Hot leather. You ever seen a dead man? You ever seen a dead man? Undertaker voice and all, nigga.
Fuck, nigga. Yo, salute to anybody that works in the business of dead people, bro.
Man.
Y'all niggas got it.
You gotta be a certain someone.
For sure. You can't even have no life outside of that shit.
I was working.
Sad, nigga. Sad every day.
I cried. I almost said some fucked up shit. I don't want to go too far.
Don't go too far. Yeah. All right, man. Hey, so we was talking a couple days ago. I forgot how we got on this subject. Oh, well, first we was talking about what's the best beat that you've ever heard?
The best beat?
The best instrumental you've ever heard to any song.
Oh my God.
I don't care about era. I don't care about is the best beat that you know?
I really like the Soulja Boy Wowzers.
All right. I didn't expect that.
I like the bass, bro. I'm sorry. It's really a lot, bro, but I really like...
It gotta be a beat from Mike Will.
I wasn't expecting
but there's but there's a lot. I mean, we can always go Kanye and deep off into people who use a lot of...
You said it's Soulja Boy Wowzers?
Yeah,
how
man.
How the fuck you spell that shit?
Soulja Boy. The Lil Wayne song Wowzers, but Soulja Boy did the beat.
Oh, okay.
That's what we're talking about right about.
Mm-hmm. Just instrumental. Oh, this shit?
This is just slaps. I'm not saying it's the best or nothing like that. It just slaps. I like it.
I want to know, what's the best beat that you've ever heard?
I don't know. Because, I mean, it probably is it's probably a sample from somewhere. I don't know, bro. You come with is some shit you probably thought of all day. And you be asking us to...
What are you talking about?
You be asking us to answer this shit.
So just give me some of your the favorite. Not necessarily number one, but just some of the top ones.
Eazy-E, Boys in the Hood. I like a lot of that rock and roll and bass in there. So I like Eazy-E, Boys in the Hood. I like Zapp and Rogers, I Want to Be Your Man.
Wait, slow down, nigga, hold up.
I thought you were asking to rattle something off.
This?
Yeah, I mean, this is just the shit I like.
Dr. Dre?
Yo, go ahead, freestyle, man.
Hey, man, B. Robbie. Go ahead.
This nigga wanna freestyle on the beat. Told your bitch gonna give me head and feet. That mean I want the shoulders, too. Bitch sick. Yeah, I got the bird flu. This cool came in the building and I'm rocking. Sean rolling up a piff, yeah, I'm about to spark it. In L.A. on his phone like, what is it? Knocking at your door, bitch, like, what is it? I'm in the basement, now I'm in the attic. I'm outside, coughing like an asthmatic. Off the weed, I'm off the drink. get a weed like a skunk, shit stank. That was real basic, but I'm on it. About to fuck the bitch till 2 in the morning. Kick her out while I'm still yawning. Tell her get off my dick. Yeah, bitch, she's yawning. Yeah, I'm Michael Jordan. 4-5 on the waist. Yeah, I'm recording. And I'm just fucking up. But LA, you wanna jump on this beat, bruh? Go ahead.
I guess you don't. Cut the beat.
He left me out to dry. It's all good, cause you still my guy. B. You took the breath.
I was just hoping you was going.
Alright, so what else? What else? What else? Fuck all that shit. What's some of your other? What's one of your favorite instrumentals, LA?
My favorite instrumentals.
It's one of the best beats that you've ever heard.
Has to be an R&B song, man.
So we didn't go. We didn't go this route.
I was just talking to
LA. You said Zappin' Rogers?
Yeah, because I was just talking to LA, man, a few weeks ago, man, about that whole New Jack Swing era, fam. Teddy Riley.
Great era.
And who else? Keke Sweat.
Great era.
And I'm pretty sure I'm missing a few names. Great era. Shout out to them.
El Biv DeVoe.
Black Street.
And all the Kid and Player. Tony.
Yeah, man. Shit, man.
You know what I'm saying? So many motherfuckers. Yeah, for sure.
But, just, I don't know. I like that kind of music, man. That's just a little different. I don't usually like the whole just bass and a clap. But I did just kind of.
That was a good era too.
I don't know, man.
Bobby Brown. We forgot to mention Bobby Brown when we talk about New Jack Swing for sure.
But you just, I don't know, you kind of came at me really out the blue with that one. I need to.
All right, what's up, LA? You done thinking?
Oh no, I didn't even think at all, bro.
Some of your favorite instrumentals. I played a Zappin' Rogers since you said it.
This gonna get to the barbecue.
This is a great instrumental. Oh yeah. Get the cookout popping. This defies generations.
That nigga, whoever on the grill, lock in.
Yeah.
He gonna lock in.
That nigga gonna tear that shit up.
Make sure you had them sandals on, though.
Like stepping, cars and shit. Keys running around. Yeah, man.
Rose in Harlem. A Rose in Harlem is a cold ass beat right now.
That's present. That's the present one. I'm gonna give you Generation.
Who was that by?
Tiana Taylor. This is one of your favorite beats of all time. That's what you're telling me?
Yeah, I was really
present right now.
I want to know what are some of your favorite instrumentals of all time, nigga.
If you listen to this podcast and you don't follow,
it's too much
New Jax or Empire X, you know LA is really a instrumentator.
Yeah, that's why I don't believe that's one of your favorite beats of all time.
This nigga picked that beat.
Because it's too many songs.
Give us a good one. Okay, we ain't asking for one. Just rattle off two.
Pick some, nigga.
Give me some.
You want me to all start, man, so you niggas.
Any beat, bro.
No Name got a song called Diddy Bop. That's a nice beat.
Oh, you talking about No Name? Come on, bro.
That's a nice beat. Diddy Bop and a Kobe. See, don't be lame, bro. Don't be lame. That shit hard.
What about favorite samples?
This is one of the coldest beats of all time.
This is not. Nigga said, "Break your fucking neck."
This is not one of the coldest instrumentals of all time. Look at him. Look at your neck.
My nigga's not moving.
He's trying not to move his shit. He's trying to bob his head right
now. Nowadays,
I
everybody.
Fuck with Buster. You know, fuck with Buster.
Nowadays, everybody got something to say. I didn't.
No, this ain't that.
What?
That beat is better than this.
Oh, still the Still Dre beat?
Yeah. With the guitar in there. Is that a guitar? Dun, dun, dun,
dun, dun. Nigga. That's only you by 112.
That's why I fuck with that. That's why I fuck with you, S. Dot. This is definitely one of the top beats of all time.
This ain't nowadays. Everybody want to talk.
He just sing all the time, man.
This ain't that song.
I shouldn't have these.
You shouldn't? Still, sit your ass down, light-skinned ass boy. Yeah, you go. Oh, look at this nigga smoking. His face changed colors.
He's back, everybody.
Only you. 112.
See how niggas going? We still having a conversation, nigga.
Only You by 112.
One of the best beats of all time. I agree, Bad Boy. All right, this is where I was going next. Since you niggas can't...
The Hitman.
Since you niggas can't answer that it's question, who are some of the best producers of all time?
Oh, my God, bro. Man, I don't know all of them. I don't know who produced this. Mike Will.
Of all time, bro. Get the fuck out of here, he bro.
Just like him.
God damn.
Like him. Who's one of them?
Mike fucking Will is one of the best producers of all time.
Yeah, lot, why bro. Not?
Hey, if y'all listen to this shit.
No, hold up. Let me
that
do
was
it.
LeVance that said that dumb
he
shit.
He said that shit, and we apologize, man, for him.
Real.
Look, I've been studying the craft really of really producing.
I'm not hating on Mike Will.
This nigga should know better. But look, I've really been studying the craft of that shit, man. And nigga. Mike Will ain't all time yet, man. He's good. He's great. Amazing. But he's not all time yet, bro.
Right.
Of all time.
Now, ooh, y'all.
I've been studying, and I may be, ooh, I may say some wrong answers.
This
but
is
I
one
like
of the best beats
like
of all
Teddy
time.
Riley.
Tell me I'm lying.
Who?
This is one of the best beats of all time.
Who produced it? No, you didn't say beats. You said producers. So I ain't trying to hear none of that shit.
I'm going to beats now. I said beats and producers. Whoever was producing for Bad Boy back in the 90s. I don't know.
Stevie J.
Yeah.
The Hitman. Look up the... Go on your laptop and look up the Hitman, bro. That was the Bad Boy... The production team, bro, was the Hitman, man. It's like five of them. That's the cold part. That's what I'll be thinking. That's what be bringing me back to Empire Rex. It's like having a production team.
Dungeon Room.
The Dungeon Room, what's that? That's the beat.
Nigga, do your research.
Tell me. Educators, teach us. I'm a student. Teach me, bro. Who's the Dungeon Room? What is it?
Outcast beats. All Outcast beats.
Oh, the Dungeon Family?
The Dungeon Same Family. Beats.
Who? I wasn't the producer. That was the crew name.
Who's Goody Mob?
Another one of the best instrumentals of all time. Can I get y'all started, bro?
You can't
come on, man.
This is the era.
This is just where I'm starting
it's
at.
It's an era, but that's what I'm saying. What makes you best of all time is that you gotta like,
and this
nigga,
shit,
you gotta have an era. You know what I'm saying? Like Mike Will, like is this his era?
No,
I don't think he's running this era. I think it's a lot of niggas in his era.
It's not his era. Metro Boomin is in here. Jahlil Beats is in.
You
come on, bro. A lot of
ain't been around long as him making hits. That's what I'm saying, bro. Who's Mike Will's hits goes way back, bro. Think this Miley Cyrus.
How long was his run?
Okay, that's one great Mike on his resume that he did a Miley Cyrus joint.
So
okay,
who you got?
Now what?
This is what I'm saying.
Rachel Merck.
Answer this question. Answer this question.
Gucci Man.
Answer the question. Is Mike Will's made its run over?
No.
He's still the top producer in this
just
era.
He just did Creed.
He did Creed what?
Two.
Two.
He produced the whole album?
Yeah.
The soundtrack?
Yeah, two.
That's what's up. I didn't know that.
All
right.
Bro, he did the whole music for Target. He did the whole music for Target for all last year in the summer.
Who did
all the music
the
on the stuff on Target commercials? That's him.
Did John Legend do that shit?
I don't know who produced 12 Years a Slave. I thought it was maybe just was the soundtrack, which was fire. But
so Mike Will made it. So you're doubling down on that.
Bro.
Mike Will made it as one of the best producers of all time,
and he's going everywhere, just like how Quincy Jones was.
He fuck with Wiz, don't he?
I don't know.
Is that why you saying that? I'm trying to figure out why you say that,
bro. Because I
he makes hard ass beats,
like the
bro.
Beats he like, bro.
He, bro, he makes hard ass.
I'm trying to figure out why. There's a reason why this nigga say that shit.
No, he makes beats, bro. If Travis Scott did nothing but make beats, he'll be in the that topic too. That nigga produced some bangers.
Yeah, definitely got some slappers. Can we put Dust Blaze and maybe can we put Ye in there?
Yeah, he's definitely
Ye's
in there.
He's in there definitely.
Scott Storch is in there.
Fuck yeah.
Who in there with some of the just
Timberland. Play Aaliyah. Any Aaliyah Genuine Missy beat, play that.
RP J Dilla.
Any instrumental.
Oh, J Dilla's definitely in there. You see, now we getting to it.
Come on, bro.
Now we getting to it.
This is easy, man. We had to get LA off that phone, man. Had to get him in his bag, man. We had to get LA at the LA Dixon, y'all. LA Dixon is the producer.
Hey, 40. 40.
He makes a beat.
We gotta give respect to Dylan.
He picked this beat. He could have picked the Common song.
Slum Village. This was his group. A 1-2. Give me 10 bars, bro. Give me 10 of them, John.
I don't even know how to count bars.
Really?
Hey, what I was saying earlier was, man, B-Rod, you said you was gonna come here. And you say you ain't gonna give us a preview of the album, but you say you're gonna give us a freestyle, a comment section freestyle, man. You ain't here yet, man. I don't know if you're coming or not, but if we don't get no freestyles episode, bro, it's a problem when I see you.
What else is one of the coldest instrumentals ever?
We're taking our invite back.
Another Boosie cold Collins. Instrumental. Boosie Collins, I'd rather be with you.
I'm about to give you one of the best instrumentals.
Michael
ever.
Jackson, rock with you. Who made it? Who made it?
Beat makers.
Dipset.
One of the best instrumentals ever. This is another one.
This nigga's just picking any beats now.
No, I'm not.
Tupac, my ambitions are the rider.
Tupac, outlaw, live and die in L.A.
Oh, shit. What's the, nigga?
Is this one?
Thug's Passion.
Anybody else make a song out of this beat?
Are we putting Dr. Dre
as
one of the best producers ever?
Yeah. Fuck yeah. That was a dumb question. Here, bro. Yeah.
One of the best beats ever.
Fab has my favorite. Fab kills this, bro. That's my favorite freestyle of this shit.
My favorite freestyle of this is Eminem's last battle on 8 Mile against
Fuck 3-1, 3-1-3
against Papa Doc, man.
3-1-3.
Can you spin this whole shit though?
No, I can't.
I can.
I bet you. Here you go.
Eminem
fan.
Oh, no, I can't. I just smoke.
Oh,
here you go. Now, while he stands tough, notice that this man did not have his hands up. This free world got you gassed up. Now, who's afraid of the big bad wolf? 1, 2, 3 into the 4. 1 Pac, 2 Pac, 3 Pac, 4. 4 Pac, 3 Pac, 2 Pac, 1. Your Pac, he's Pac, your Pac, none.
That shit was
That's all I remember.
Shit was like, you know what my shit was?
Super overrated.
You know what my shit was? Hold on, let it ride. This nigga said this. He said,
Let's be
rad. 1, 2, 3, go! Yeah, I may be white, but give a style, his soul is black as night, and I don't want to fight. I'd rather fly a kite.
Oh my god, this nigga spit that B-Rad G.
That shit was hard. Kendrick Lamar has some cold ass beats.
For sure. Of all time, though?
Nigga, motivate.
I mean, of all time. Don't be a prisoner of the moment.
Otis.
Can we get that Ambitions of the Rider real quick?
Otis.
Otis by Kanye and Jay-Z. Touch the Sky, Kanye West.
Of all time?
Come on, man. Heard him say. Beats, you ain't hearing the beats? So you know the words that's coming out of my mouth.
Serious moment. Is this one of the best beats of all time?
Wrapped in fofos.
Yeah.
Yes, nigga.
I think it's like every
gave
every,
you Nintendo. Bob said 10, so that's they can't see up in my window. Nigga, I was gonna rip the whole thing.
I'm the meanest, and I'm meanest. Sound fiendish, but I'm a genius. Man, Lupe?
Oh, that's what you thought of?
Oh, my God.
I get the original joint. I'm sorry.
What me, I thought of. I got the internet going nuts. My team balling like the sun balling up. Yeah. It's H-Town, baby. What you know about me? I'm on that time now.
Yeah, that right there. That's what I thought of.
I'm dipping. Catch me late dripping with the paint dripping. Look at your name missing.
Oh, you should have played a song. Play the song. Play song. Could be that outro song, nigga. We done. What you want to do?
No, we ain't done, nigga.
Play the song.
We still got one more topic, nigga.
Play the song, man.
What's the last topic? I gotta go, man.
Huh?
I gotta go, man. What's the last topic?
I'll play that shit to the end. The last topic. All right, so we started off there with some of the best beats of all time, right? We gave y'all a few of them. There's a lot more that we didn't even touch on. I didn't play no Kanye beats. I didn't play no Tim beats.
No Zaytoven.
Whatever.
You can't.
So my next thing is, so what are some of the best hip hop love songs of all time? I'm gonna let y'all think and marinate on it.
Wow, can't say of all time, bro.
Of all time, you nigga. Yes, I can.
You can't do that to music, bro.
Yes, I can.
Cause what makes it an all time?
We're not whatever. Ranking.
What's your, the yeah? Said he said of all, bro. He said of all time.
I said your favorites, bro. It don't gotta. It's not a consensus. Bro. I don't want the universal.
Be 1, 2, 3.
I don't have. I got more than. I got weeks, more. Right? I can't. They all my favorite. That's the thing.
Just say some of them, in, nigga. I'll start.
Say some hitters too.
I'll start.
Yo, you gonna say some weak shit? Cause I got some.
No, I'm not.
Hip hop, you said hip hop love song.
Love songs of all time.
Okay.
My top artist is gonna be the Coldest.
I'm not coming. You said my first one's gonna be like my off the bench one.
Here we go.
I'm gonna hit y'all in the head with something.
I'm gonna hit you in the fucking head right quick.
You wait until somebody else say it first. That's all.
Number one.
Go ahead.
I see your phone song because I'm yes.
Yeah, pass your phone around. That was trash. That
what?
Was
I'm talking about. No, you gotta go.
He trying to pick this one the safe route.
Let the first ride.
No, this the safe route. This the safe route. Everybody knows this is the first hip hop love song.
What?
This is the first hip hop love song. Of course, you can't go wrong with this. Don't try to. You pick the easy way out.
This is not an easy way out.
That is an easy way
you
out.
You think so?
Yeah, you can't pick another one. That's why you pick this one. You're trash.
Just wait.
What you mean? Just wait. You gonna pick Jay-Z a Jay-Z song? No, come on, man. He's trash. This guy.
I'm not picking a Jay-Z song. That's too easy.
Bro, he like this. Bro, he picked this one. This is easy.
This is not easy.
This is easy.
My shit's sneaky.
White people know this song.
This is easy. It's Method Man. It's Method Man.
Never ever give my pussy away and keep it tight.
White people fuck with Method Man.
Right, Wu Tang, motherfucker.
Thousands of kids.
He gonna be mad at me because I'll pick something up today. He gonna be like, how you gonna pick Loyalty by this nigga?
That's not a hip hop song.
That is.
You gonna pick Loyalty?
And I got tomorrow, I'm saying that is a hip hop song.
You my nigga.
I'm just saying.
I definitely got the best one of you picking that.
This is gonna be my first song on my wedding, nigga.
Okay.
This is gonna be the song me and my wife dance to.
Okay. Go ahead.
All right, go ahead.
He ain't gonna have.
Really?
Jay-Z?
It's LL Cool J?
Yeah.
Get the fuck out of here.
Oh, damn, my bad.
Hey, this is a good song, though. I can't lie. I was in sixth grade when this shit came out. I remember
you
it.
You wrote a note to this. You definitely wrote a note, nigga.
Yeah. Yeah. But this is not even the best LL Cool J love song.
I feel you, but I gave you one that... I gave you a hitter still.
You did.
I gave you a hitter. Just give me my credit. This nigga, man. What you...
He about to play some bullshit. Some Wiz Khalifa. Shout out to J-Lo. He's playing Wiz. Yeah, Wiz.
Hey, okay. Hey, should I take it?
No, that's where the slander stops, nigga. That's the best Wiz album ever. You still,
there. Y'all good? Yeah, is that cool?
Yeah, go ahead, go ahead.
I'm good.
It's easy as fuck.
Let me see that shit.
That definitely drum on my nigga.
Yeah, talk you all that shit. Talk all that shit. I just killed your shit.
That's definitely a good one. Oh.
You didn't kill my
yeah. Nigga. You didn't know this was. You had to, it had to get you.
You didn't even know the intro of the album.
Yeah, see?
This is the goddamn. Yeah, I don't want this. Yeah, there we go.
No 30. You gotta let this ride through. You better respect the loop,
look,
bro.
Look, he about to beat your ass. Respect the loop, bro. Hey, watch your St. Louis ass come out here.
Hey, nigga, you better.
Another round or what? Oh, yeah. I definitely won that round.
No, you didn't. I just won that.
You definitely lost. If anything is between me and my mans, you lost. Yes, definitely.
If anything is between me and
you
him.
You picked the most.
You didn't even pick LL's best hip hop love song, nigga.
He did. But that's cool. That's,
come on, son.
He's still in it.
You should have. Yeah.
I'm just saying.
You didn't even play I Need Love, nigga. If you was going to go LL, you know where to go.
Bro,
you know where to go I with LL. Love. Yeah.
Okay.
Cool. You
that's
know.
Easy one, that's what I thought. That's why
I didn't want to do. Like, I didn't want. I thought, sir, that's like a Jay-Z one being off limits. I thought that was. I thought the Holy Grail ones was off limits. I was going. I'm coming with. Some shit.
Y'all was coming with B-sides. That's what you're saying.
Yeah, I told you at the beginning. I was coming off the bench.
I was
coming.
Yeah, turn that up. Turn that up real fast.
Holy Grails is off limits, bro.
I see you ain't press play.
But you know what? I feel like Dilemma is a Holy Grail.
No, I didn't.
Dilemma is a Holy Grail, but we're going to let you slide.
Dilemma, that's
a Holy
Grail.
What?
Okay, I can't lie.
Yeah.
No, Dilemma is already. It's already.
If you're from the Midwest, it's a Holy Grail.
I remember that summer.
I mean, you know it was a hit.
I remember that summer.
But y'all didn't pick it.
Yeah.
But y'all didn't pick it.
Round two.
Just like you picked he picked the first
round two
love hip hop song, though.
I'm going classics.
Okay, go ahead.
Round two, bro.
Y'all ready?
I don't got nothing yet. I'm gonna figure mine out when I get the phone.
Here we go.
Yeah, we don't hear shit.
So, I typed a text to the girl I used to see, saying that's
the shit I'm talking about.
To the with whom I wanna be. And I apologize if this message gets you down. And I CC every girl that I CC round town. And hate to see y'all frown, but I'd rather see her smiling. Witness all around me, true. But I'm no island, peninsula maybe. Makes no sense, I know crazy. Give up all this.
I'm playing this shit till Pimp C's verse. I'm not disrespecting this nigga.
Don't come equipped with the rear view mirrors. They dip as quick as they can. The atmosphere is now ripped. I'm so like a pimp. I'm glad it's night. So the light from the sun would not burn me on my bum when I shoot the moon. How jump the broom like a preemie out the moon. My partner yelling too soon. Don't do it. Reconsider. Read some leather. Sure on the subject. You sure? Fuck it. You know we got your back like cowboy crack. Tick if that bitch do you dirty. We'll wash your ass out as in detergent. Now hurry, hurry. Go on to the altar. I know you ain't a pimp, but pimp, remember what I taught you. Keep your heart.
You got it.
Keep your heart. Hey, keep your heart. Three stacks, keep your heart. Man, these girls are smart. Three stacks, these girls are smart.
Rest in peace, Pimp C, nigga.
My bitch a choosin'. Never fuck without a rubber. Never in the seats like it on top of the cover. Money on the dresser. Drive a compressor. Top notch holes. Get the most, not the lesser. Trans like the fuck of $40 in the
cave. Fuck it
up the game.
That bitch it gets
up,
no man. Love.
She be cross country.
Pass it up. Smash up the gray one, bought me a red.
Every time we hit the parking lot, we turn head. Some hoes wanna choose, but can get the two fairy. If bitch chose me,
you ain't a pimp, you a fairy.
Hit.
Shout out to that nigga Pimp C.
He said the first one was a and the second one was his real hit. He ain't even got
my hit was a Jay-Z one. Typical. He's gonna play Bonnie and Clyde.
Nah, he was gonna use Change Clothes.
That's not a hip hop.
Absolutely not, bro. I'm gonna pass my turn.
Thank you, bro.
Oh shit, you pop a
to the master. To the master, the shit. Pop
a you choke.
You definitely have the master.
Palms are sweaty.
Can I go? Can I rock them?
Knees weak, arms is heavy. Yeah, go ahead.
Can I go out there?
You know what your song is?
Who?
You don't know.
Who you talking to?
You don't know.
I'm the truth and not a fable. Don't ever play me, bro.
Hey, rest in peace to Pimp C, man. One of the realest to ever do it. Or should I say one of the trillest to ever do it. Salute to H-Town.
Yeah, I got mine, B. Hopefully he don't steal it, though.
03 Bonnie and Clyde?
Nah, it's cold, too. But if he get it, it's gonna be like...
Drunk in Love?
It's gonna be...
You better play Drunk in Love?
LeBron blocked Iggy.
Oh, what else? Or like Game 6s?
If he's not there, I'm dunking it, nigga.
We already all get all the way to big boy, huh?
Yeah.
I thought you already had it. Yeah. So it's not true, not a fable.
My selection. Girl, don't touch my protection. I know you won't get to slip. What?
Slippers, I don't slip.
For life. That's like making it rain every month on schedule. Let me tell you, get your papers on the roller, cause it's gonna get better. Better prepare your mother, see, suppose she's supposed to spend it on that baby, but we see she
does. Paul McCartney,
the noise couldn't stop. Slaughter.
He might have to pass his turn too, bro.
He might. No, I can keep going.
Might be up one on
this. I can keep going.
No, this is the thing.
Let me get it back, bro.
No, this is the thing. I don't want to get disqualified. I don't want you guys to say, no, this ain't.
There ain't no rules to this shit, nigga. Hip hop love song. It has to be primarily from a hip hop artist. It can't be an R&B song with a hip hop feature. That's what I'm saying. That's the only rule.
Oh my god, what?
What?
Yeah, see, break down
the rule. No, I still got it though.
It can't be an R&B singer with a hip hop feature.
Still cold.
It has to be from a hip hop artist.
God, this nigga's trash.
He played Drake?
No,
this better be the ad. This better be the ad.
Is this Drake? No, ain't no ads.
I didn't mean to.
This nigga play Drake.
Oh, I was gonna go to Drake.
Drake what?
Love for passion.
What?
What? No, that's song. The first song. On this thing. It was an accident. It was the first song you got right there.
Well, play your real song. Because
it was because Drake.
So it should
kills.
Be easy to get back to your song. What?
Yeah, he was bugging on that Drake shit. I think he played it on purpose.
You should have did these round.
So Drake don't count. See, this is what I just said. I said I want to pick something, and then y'all gonna be like, so I picked Drake, and y'all like,
okay. Let's move on.
We didn't say we wasn't gonna shit on it. We didn't say if it was a trash ass pick that we wasn't gonna say nothing.
Man, he got so many hits, I can pick any.
So you sticking with Drake? That's what you gonna live and die on?
Drake can win. If you just said,
so you won. Let's go.
It depends on what song. Passion Fruit wasn't winning. Just hard to play Drake.
Bro, it was an accident.
What, you gonna play Marvin's Room? Go ahead, bro.
He's really
good. And I just passed
really
it. No,
to,
I'm
you
not
can
gonna
play Fire and Desire.
Bro.
Or some shit like that.
That's not hip hop.
Oh, I mean, he's a hip hop artist, isn't he?
Who? It's hip hop.
He's a hip hop artist.
Who?
Drake.
Is it a love song?
Fire and Desire is a song?
He's a hip hop artist, and it's a love song, right?
That's called Fire and Desire?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you were talking about Rick James.
You playing for some Rick
no,
James?
No, I thought he was talking about Rick James.
Okay, can you pick your song, though?
All right, man. I'm just not trying to get disqualified because y'all talk about niggas. Oh, you got Drake?
Well, let me pick mine. You don't know yours. Let me pick mine.
Yes, I do. I'm looking for it.
It shouldn't be that hard.
I'm
going to
type it in there.
He didn't search for it. He was looking for them references.
He's looking for a Drake song. What was you looking for?
Yeah, man. Just looking for it. I had to look at all the
Drake
songs.
Nah, he was looking for... What was you looking for?
Man, any of them, man. You had to see.
He's doing, Shut It Down.
He's looking for Prom Queen.
Shut It Down.
Oh, man.
See, it was all so true.
Oh, I know shit.
It seems like everything I do, you're used to it.
I won. I beat both of y'all, both rounds.
This is a breakup song.
It's a love song. Is it a love song?
So you still think I'm confident and dumb. Is this gonna last? You're upon a pedestal. Are we moving too fast?
It was either this or Sooner Than Later. Cause
Sean,
them are older.
Sean, this
those
is kind of a love song.
See, y'all, see, that's what I'm talking about.
I do. I know you're a fan.
Look at this nigga.
Okay.
Fabulous.
No, that's a good artist to pick.
It was.
Yeah. That's what the fuck
he's
supposed to
he
do.
He could have put it so into you. That's what I would have picked.
Huh? That's a Tamia song. He said he could be a Tamia song.
That was. That's his song.
That's Tamia's song.
No, he's his song.
No.
Yes.
I'm so
they got
his original song and then it's a remix, right? Or he did his own and then put her on it.
Yes. No, he had her as the sample and then was like, fuck it, come sing it. The sample that I had you sing. This ain't that. I could have picked that one.
You didn't win. You didn't win. I picked Drake. Drake. Who sold more? Who's a bigger artist?
White tee.
What's a little bit of type.
What's a better song?
Brand New.
Who affects? So
you don't remember? So what was you doing right here?
Brand New. When this came?
Very much so.
What was you doing when this song came out?
What was you doing? What you doing?
You wasn't outside this summer?
I'm asking you your experience. What this song made you think of? What you doing?
This song makes me think of the summertime. We had Farview hooping. We trying to chop up girls. Niggas was
near. You wasn't that old, bro. Trying to talk to no girls in Farview, bro.
We was in middle school when this song came out.
No, you wasn't, nigga.
Yeah, we was.
No, you wasn't. I was in the fifth grade.
I was in the fifth grade
when this song came out, bro.
No, you wasn't.
Yes, I was. Don't play with me.
Nigga, we was in middle school when this shit came out.
What year came out?
I don't know.
It say it on there. So I copy one. Nah, it
said the year was uploaded to YouTube.
Oh, see.
What jersey you got on?
The jerseys? This is the video where she was on the skates. We was going skating with this shit. Bro, come on. We was outside. All right,
man. So niggas don't remember Brand New coming out in high school. And like that shit didn't have a way.
You just had to hear that shit.
On MySpace. Stop playing. It was on MySpace.
It didn't come out. You had to hear it.
It was on MySpace.
Like a big artist dropped that. Like, oh, you nigga, you heard that? No, you had
to go on his MySpace.
He was in Hopkins at that time.
Yeah,
so shut up. You probably was over in Tappan.
Brand New
somewhere
was a good song.
Brand New was the shit.
But it's not Fab, though, nigga. Come on, bro. All
right, man. Go ahead. You got another one?
Yeah.
Is it a theme
this round? That Fab song remind me of skating.
It's a theme this
me
round?
Me too, because the bitch was
in the round. I won this round, so let me pick the theme.
You might have won the round.
So let me pick all right, the what's theme? The theme? I get to go first.
Now. All right, go ahead.
I'm not getting to go first. He ain't even got one. He's scared as hell. The niggas is going to pick him for him.
Get your weak ass out of here, man. What the fuck with this, man?
That's a good choice with that
it's time
Fab,
to go, man. I got to go.
Nah, you don't got to go nowhere, bro. Come on, man. Chill. It's only 7.
Yeah, man. I got to go to the mall.
What mall?
Rip Rosa.
Why you got to go there?
Cause man,
shit on close to 10. You straight.
Yeah, man, we gonna head end it, man. Play that still tipping, man. We gonna head end it.
Let me
bro.
See.
You gotta get up out of here.
Damn,
man.
LA fucker. We just getting into a groove, nigga. We only 2 minutes
he's
and
leaving,
46
because
seconds.
He's leaving next. How long we at?
Huh? We had
2 hours.
Oh yeah, 2 hours and 46 minutes.
Right. Oh, okay, man. We did good. Came way off of him, man. Leave it by that low.
We gonna keep this topic going in another episode. Yeah, that's me.
You trying to make it? Shut your snitching ass.
All right, man. It's the comment section podcast. Remember to hit subscribe on iTunes and SoundCloud. Coming soon to YouTube. Make sure that you 5-star us. Give us a nice rating on iTunes.
Please.
Leave a comment on SoundCloud. Let us know what your favorite subject was. If there's subjects that you want to hear us talk about that we didn't talk about, let us know. Leave feedback, whatever, negative, positive, whatever you guys say. Let us know. We're gonna holler at y'all next week. It's Cool Keem, Sean.LA. We out. Salute to Mike Jones.
So, folks, I'm tipping.
R.I.P.
Rolling in the mix, it's that 6'6" long dick slim nigga sticking your chick, pulling tricks, looking slick at all times when I'm flipping, bar sipping, car dipping, grand boy grain gripping, still tipping on the toe, now so rolling, and no hangers, and no hangers, so blowing on that endo, GameCube Nintendo, 5% tint, so you can't see up in my window, these niggas don't understand me, cause I'm boss hog on candy.
Where's peanut butter at?
Texas with a big Glock 9 handy. Pieced up, creased
hey.
Up, stand dressed to impress. Big boss, Bill Bubba under my Mitchell and S. Gucci shades
yeah.
up on my braids when I escalate.
Oh,
when I'm riding,
oh, spring
wheels sliding like an escapade. I got
I
it made, the big boss of the North. Ain't shit changed, but still represents what's your house. Switching with the paint dripping,
hey.
Turn your neck and your guy ain't missing. Me and Slim, we ain't tripping. I'm thinking flipping the service, sipping like do or die. I'm dope pimping. Car stop, red seat spinning. I'm flipping, drop with a double top. Home bop my
my top step out. I'm shaking the block with a 418. 10 degree with a lemon stain. My gasoline always supreme. Got dirt on the brand with a pantaline. It takes grinding to be a king. It takes grinding to be a king. Drake Brown drop beef. I'm coming. Chimbo is Mike Jones. Coming. Slap shining with a grill and woman. Slap shining with a grill and woman. Mike Jones. Mike Jones. I'm on the road. You can't come. I got a lot of brothers and a lot of homies. Some friends and some homies. Back then, hoes in the moment. Now I'm hot, hoes all on me. Back then, hoes in the moment. Now I'm hot, hoes all on me. Back then, hoes in the moment. Now I'm hot, hoes all on me. Back then, hoes in the moment. Now I'm hot, hoes all on me.
I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to